Good morning, everybody. It's Sunday morning. It is Sunday surprise. Oh, yeah. Welcome on today's episode of It's the Game Show Time War in Vertivision. Today, we got the NBC Daytime lineup from the summer of 79 with Card Sharks, Hollywood Squares, High Rollers, Wheel of Fortune, the Fabulous Mind Readers, and Password Plus. Sit back and relax. We'll be back.
Mr. Green?
Yeah.
You need any help?
Mm-mm.
I just want you to know, I think you're the best ever.
Yeah, sure.
Want my Coke? It's okay, you can have it.
No.
Really, you can have it.
Okay.
A Coke and a smile makes me feel good. Makes me feel nice.
Be around.
That's the way it should be. I like to see.
Hey, kid.
The whole world is smiling with me. Coca-Cola has life. Have a Coke and
a thanks, Mean Joe.
Smile.
For joining us. Delighted to have you back. And you're very kind. And we thank Pete Whalen of Madison, Wisconsin for the opening poem. Pete's watching us on WMTV-TV, Channel 15. Thank you, Pete. Now let's get to the cards. Janice and Markey, if you will, start loading in the cards, and we'll meet our card sharks. Tenny Garner, our champion. Hi, Tenny. A vision in orange today. Won't you tell us about yourself once again?
I'm Tenny Garner. I'm originally from Idaho, met a Californian in college, moved down here, became a vice principal of a high school, and to get some of that stress level off, I took up flying this summer.
Are you now? Do you have your license yet?
Not yet.
How long is it going to take?
Longer.
Longer. Well, you made some money to pay for the lessons. You've won $6,975 in cash. You can almost buy a plane, I would think.
Almost.
Our challenger is Sandra Speer. Hi, Sandra.
How do you do?
Nice to see you again. Won't you again tell us about yourself?
Well, I'm Sandra Speer, originally from London. Have lived in South Africa, have lived in Brazil. And when my son was coming to the States to go to university, I thought I'd come and investigate to see about the Indian scalping and the gangsters mowing him down. I found it was a delightful country, fell in love with it, and now I'm living in San Clemente.
We could definitely elect you queen, Sandra. That's what... Now, your accent, I have heard many English accents, but you have the purest what we think of an English accent. Were you born in London? Is that a London accent?
Well, I must tell you, in England, you know, it doesn't matter where you come from. It's what school you've been to. We have certain schools, which are sort of private schools, and people that go to those schools speak with a certain accent. It doesn't matter if you come from Scotland, England, Ireland, Wales.
The school, not the district.
Not the district.
Your accent is delightful. Happy to have you here with us again.
Thank you both.
Cut the cards before we went on the air?
Yes.
And here we go. We'll pick up as we play the best two games out of three. We are in the middle of game number one. Looking at the board, Tenny the champion has yet to turn over a card. And Sandra the challenger has moved over. She has a six as her base card. She needs three cards. This is question two in game number one. Sandra, as we left off, it goes to you. Sandra, we found 100 engaged women. These are all women who plan to be married within the next 6 months. And we asked them, forgive a frank question, but right now, engaged women, are you pregnant? How many engaged women admitted they are?
Well, I've seen many brides today going to the altar with a little bit more than they expected to. And I think say about 35.
35. We're pregnant.
You talk to them and they were 6 months waiting to be married, they're waiting too late. I think that number's going to be lower.
Lower.
Yeah.
If it is lower, Tenny, you'll play your cards first. If not, it'll be Sandra. I don't know the answer, Sandra, but if you're right at 35, let's see. The actual number of engaged women who said they are pregnant is one. It's lower. Just one. Yeah, 6 months is a long time. Tenny, you start off with a five.
Let's change the card.
Winning the question, you can change your base card. A king, a great change.
Okay, lower.
Lower than a king, a jack.
Lower.
She's going to risk it lower. No, an ace is not lower. And you lose both cards back to the base card, giving Sandra a free chance to play off the six.
Higher.
Higher than the six? No, a two is not higher. Were you giving the audience a look like, see, I went along with you and you were wrong? Janice fills in the spaces with the next cards off the top of your deck. Question to you, Tenny. Tenny, we asked 103rd grade kids, when your parents scold you, do you ever pretend to cry just so they'll lay off? How many third graders said, yeah, they've pretended to cry?
Oh, yes. Yes. The more you cry, the less they're going to beat you, you know? And I think the number's going to be high. Let's see. It's going to be not that high. It's going to be 47.
47 have pretended to cry. Sandra?
10 grades, about 8 years old.
I'm sorry, Sandra?
Third grade's about 8 years old.
Third grade? How old would a third grader is be? About around eight or so. Our audience says, yeah, around that age.
Oh, I think a little higher.
A little higher than 47. They can more use their wiles. The actual number of third graders who pretended to cry is 46, not higher, Tenny.
Good, okay.
Within one of being right on with a king.
Okay, let's go lower.
Playing the king lower? Oh, no. Tenny's getting a lot of big cards, and again, Sandra, a free chance for you.
Higher.
Higher than the six. This time it is.
Freeze.
Now we move over the freeze bar, protecting that position with Sandra needing two cards. Tenny needs four. It is sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Sandra, we polled 100 actors and actresses who appear regularly in a TV soap opera. And we asked them, tell the truth. Do you sometimes think you're overpaid for what you do? How many actors admitted sometimes they think they're overpaid?
Well, acting is a very time profession. I've done acting, and anything, I think, in TV where it's repetitious and repetitious, I don't think they think they're overpaid.
How many do, though?
Think they're overpaid.
How many think they're overpaid?
15.
15. 15 out of 100 think they're overpaid, Tenny.
They work really hard, and they're every day. And I think it's going to be lower.
Lower than that?
Yeah.
Well, this will decide control of the board. The actual number of actors who think they're overpaid is 21, not lower. Sandra. Now, Sandra's not even waiting for me to explain the options, but in case you want to change your mind, it is sudden death with a 10. You need two cards. Tenny is a king. She needs four. Are you passing it? That's what I thought you were doing. Tenny, if you could turn them all over, you win the game. One mistake, the game belongs to the challenger.
Okay, lower.
Lower than the king. This time it is.
Lower.
Lower than the nine. No, it's not lower. And Sandra wins game one in sudden death. So it is game one to the challenger. And now the champion's got to make a comeback. Can she do it? We'll find out right after this. The challenger with $100, and now Janice is dealing out the same two decks of cards. The next card's off the top of the deck. Starting game two, and Tenny, I think this is the first time you've been behind. I think you've been ahead in all of your matches.
She's really chasing.
Well, let's see if the queen can come from behind against the Queen of England here.
Oh.
Tenny, a major reason that the police are called is to settle family disputes. That's a fact. So we asked 100 policemen, in your experience, does the wife start most family disputes? How many policemen said, yes, it is the wife?
I think a lot of women start arguments. Men end them. No, and I think that number is going to be fairly high. I think it's going to be about 62.
Tenny says 62 policemen said the women start the arguments.
Well, I don't know. You know, sometimes men have a little too much to drink, and they come home, and they're battling before they even put their foot in the door. I mean, the wife hasn't even got to say hello, and they say, you know. So I think, really, it's a little lower.
You say lower. I don't know what she said, but she said it so well. Lower. The actual number of policemen who think the wife starts most family disputes is 67, not lower. Tenny, 67. She was very close. And the champion has some catching up to do. A king.
Yeah, okay, lower.
Lower than a king, a seven.
Please.
Move over the freeze bar. Tenny takes the one card advantage. Sandra, this question to you. Sandra, we found 100 house husbands. These are all men who stay home and take care of the house and kids while their wife works. And we asked them, do your children ever call you mommy? How many house husbands said their children have called them mommy?
Well, I don't think that's very high, because a mother's a mother. I think about 10, maybe.
10. Higher or lower, Tenny?
I think everybody at one time, calls someone by a name other than what they are. So I think it's going to be...
She says 10.
Higher.
The actual number of house husbands who've had their kids call them mommy is 15. Tenny is right. It is higher.
Ah, change my card.
And Tenny can get rid of that 7 now. With a 9.
Oh, well, it isn't a lot better. Okay, it's going to be lower.
Lower than a 9. Yes, a 3.
Yeah, it's going to be higher.
Higher than a 3 and 10.
3.
And now as we move over the freeze bar, Tenny needs one card to tie up the match. Question 3 to you, Tenny. Tenny, we asked 107th grade kids to complete the following phrase. Men seldom make passes at girls who... What?
Wear glasses.
Well, how many 7th graders knew that saying that you know? Men seldom make passes at girls who wear glasses. 7th graders.
Fairly high. It's easy to rhyme. You know, kids get into the rhyming thing right away for 2nd, 3rd grade. So I think it's going to be a pretty high number. I think it's going to be about 69.
69 out of 107th graders knew men seldom make passes at girls who wear glasses.
I don't really know if children take so much interest in glasses, who wears them and who doesn't. So I think it's a little lower.
So you say lower. Besides which, glosses doesn't rhyme with passes, does it? No. You say lower. The actual number of 7th graders who knew that men seldom make passes at girls who wear glosses is 12. It is much lower. 12. Incidentally, one of the 7th grade kids in the poll said men seldom make passes at girls who are over 40. That was on the poll. Sandra. Sandra starts off the game with an ace.
Ooh. Lower.
Lower than the ace. A 10.
Lower.
What?
Lower.
Lower. She's sneaking up on this one. Lower. No, it's not lower. And that's a big break for Tenny. With a 10, call this.
Okay. It's going to be lower.
If this is lower, Tenny ties up the match for the win. Yes, she's tied it up. $100, the tiebreaker coming up right after this.
For really tough messes, you don't want to use a sponge because it can redeposit germs that have grown inside. Try Bounty. It's quilted. With durability closer to a sponge, it won't fall apart like this ordinary paper towel. So you avoid using sponges that can redeposit germs.
We have a tie. Each player with one game and $100. We set up for the tiebreaker with three cards up there. Three questions here, and in a very good match, we start the tiebreaker with a question to you, Sandra. Sandra, we found 100 women who are dating a married man. And we asked them, if your married boyfriend were to leave his wife and marry you, could you trust him to be faithful to you? How many women said they would trust him?
Well, you know, once he's been unfaithful, unless they think that he's really madly in love with them, I don't know.
How many would trust
up
him?
Up the middle, I think, about 40.
40 out of 100 would trust him if he married them.
Oh, I believe that a woman really thinks, I do anyway, that she's, you know, the end. No, I didn't mean it that way, but I mean, you know, she's got it. If he'd leave the other woman, she's obviously got it. I think the number.
How many would trust him? She said 40.
Trust him. The number's going to be higher.
You say higher. More would trust. I must say, before we find out the answer, when I asked the question, everything was quiet, and one lady's world-weary voice said, never happen. No. All right. Sandra says that 40 would trust him. Tenny says even more than that. The actual number of women who would trust their married boyfriend to be faithful is 31, not higher. Sandra. Sandra starts the tiebreaker with a 7.
May I change it?
You may indeed. Winning the question, she can change it. Oh, another 7.
Ooh. Higher.
Higher than a 7? No, a 2 is not higher. Tenny gets a free chance with a 3.
Higher.
Higher than a 3. A 5, 6. She's going to try to go for it for the championship. She did it. Well, just give that champion one crack and she goes. Sandra, you played a great match. Thank you so much. Delightful meeting you.
Lovely meeting you.
And we have $100 and some nice party gifts.
Thank you.
Sandra Spear, come on down here, Tenny. Well, the mark of a great champion. You came from behind to win that one.
She had me running scared.
It's the first time you made a comeback like that.
Oh, wow.
Sensational win for Tenny. She now has another $200 added to her winnings. That's up over the 7,000 mark. $7,175 right now in cash.
I love it.
And we're going to try to add to that total right now.
Yeah.
Before we went on the air, you cut the money cards, yes?
Yes.
In the event that
yes,
you would win. So here we go. They're cut. And come on up there for the money cards. Marky and Janice will start dealing them out as we give you $200 of new money on the bottom line. And these three cards, to bet as you will. Move up to the second level, another $200 of betting money, three more cards. Minimum bets, remember, $50 till you get to the top card, the big bet. There you must risk at least half the money. Come on, Tenny,
okay.
Here's $200. And remember, too, you can change that base card at each of the three levels if you need to. $200 and a queen.
Ah, it's good. I'll keep it. That's going to be $100 lower.
$100, half the money that this card is lower than a queen. It is.
Ah, okay, that's what you get. $50, it's going to be lower.
$50 minimum bet. Lower than an 8. Yes, with a 7.
Oh, $50 higher.
$50 higher than a 7? Oh. But you held back in $300 on that bottom line. And as we move up the 4, we give you the other $200. You have $500.
I'll take the card and I'll bid $300 higher.
$300 higher than a 4.
No.
Back down to $200, but there are three cards to go, Tenny. Come on.
Okay. It's going to be higher, and I'll bet $100 higher.
$100 higher than a 3. Yes.
Yeah.
There's
okay.
A good card.
King. Okay. It's going to be $250 lower.
$250 lower than a king. No. Oh, what a time for an ace to come up.
Of course I'm going to
bet
it all.
Well, you've got a big decision to make now, Tenny. Whoever you are.
All of it. Lower.
For $100. Lower than an ace.
Come on, it's
the
gonna be.
The tension mounts on this, friends. Lower than an ace. It is. Oh. Definitely is it. And she'll meet a new challenger and try to add to her total right after this. Okay, Kenny, Janice is dealing out two brand new decks of cards. It's time to meet a new challenger on Card Sharks. Rich Vaxey. Hello, Rich.
Hi, Jim. How you doing?
Good.
Nice to see you.
Won't you tell us about yourself?
Yes, my name is Richard Vaxey. I'm from Sable, New York. My brother and I just drove cross country. I'm living in West L.A., and I'll be a junior majoring in motion picture TV at UCLA next fall.
Oh, terrific. Yes. What do you want to do as a result of a degree there?
Well, my writing abilities have won some acclaim, and I've done some TV writing. I have an agent, and I'm pretty well off, and I hope to direct myself in that direction. And
terrific. Good. We wish you well, and
thank
we wish you well here. You cut your cards?
Yes, I did.
Then here we go. Okay. Starting the match with a question to Tenney. And, Tenney, we asked 100 bachelors. Have you ever plowed into the rear of the car in front of you because you were too busy watching the rear end walking across the street? How many bachelors admitted they rear-ended a car because they were paying attention to a pretty girl?
I was in a car one time when a guy almost, he went off of a bridge and nearly hit a tree, stopped him from going in the river. And I think that number is going, I think it's going to be medium. I'm going to guess 32.
32 out of 100.
I know. If I had a dime for every time I almost did that, I could pay my college tuition. So I think that number might just be a little bit higher than
higher
that.
Higher than that?
Yes.
The actual number of bachelors who rear-ended a car because they were too busy watching a pretty girl is 19. It is not higher. Tenney. 19. I guess coming close doesn't count. The question was how many hit them. Tenney starts with a 7.
Yeah. Change the card.
Oh, getting rid of the 7. That card was not exposed, I believe. This card was sitting here. It did drop, so the rule is if a card drops, it is we take care of, get rid of it, so the next card fills that space, and now the card that makes the change, okay?
Yeah.
Tenney, we change the 7 to a 9.
Lower.
Lower than a 9. An ace is not lower. Rich, great for you. A free chance and an ace.
Oh, great. Fantastic. Lower, lower.
Lower than the ace.
Another ace.
So neither player could advance. My apologies about that card dropping, Tenney, but the rule is if it drops, we do not play it. Rich, the question goes to you.
Yes.
And, Rich, we asked 100 registered Republicans. If Ronald Reagan ran for president in 1980, would you vote for him? How many Republicans would vote for Reagan in 1980?
I know he's getting a little old, and that's the problem with him. I know a lot of people don't like him.
It's the problem with all of us, Rich.
I know that. But still, I think he's got large support around the country, especially in California. I'd say about 65.
65 out of 100 registered Republicans would vote for Reagan if he ran for president.
Can I ask when you took the poll?
When we take the poll, the poll was fairly recent. Yes.
Fairly recent.
Yes. We always keep the polls up to date.
And you said 65.
65.
I think it's going to be higher.
Even higher than that?
Yeah, I do.
The actual number of Republicans who would vote for Ronald Reagan for president in 1980 is 48.
All right, okay.
Rich.
It's going to be good. It's got to be lower.
Still looking at an ace.
Okay, it's got to be lower.
Lower than an ace?
Okay, higher. Give me higher.
Higher than a 3, a 7.
All right, freeze there.
And we move over the freeze bar that protects that position. Rich, the challenger, needs 2 cards for the first game of the match. And once again, the champion is behind. We'll be right back with these nice people right after this.
Followed by Child's Play.
Well, that's about all the time we have for now. We'll pick up with this match in our next show and invite Rich and Tenney back. I hope we'll invite you back as well. Had Tenney mentioned a point there about the poll, when was it taken? And our staff makes it a point. We always keep the polls as up-to-date as possible. And if it's something about current events, you can be sure that poll will be current. So maybe you can learn something. And I hope have a good time once again with us on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
Some of our contestants will receive Light and Easy, the lightweight iron from General Electric. Handles the same ironing jobs as a heavier iron. And polyglycol protection for your car. A heat-activated formula that penetrates, protects. Polyglycol won't let Mother Nature rip you off. Available at new car dealers everywhere. And a pen set, a new improved cleaning pledge. With a whole new system of cleaners for fresh, clean beauty every time without the worry of buildup. And the serving tray and light lunch. Hot, delicious noodles in rich, thick sauces with about half the calories of a cheeseburger. Light lunch from Lipton. This is Gene.
Can you see what's right in front of your eyes? Then follow your nose to Now You See It with Jack Nahrs next. Then stay tuned for Blockbusters, only on Game Show Network.
This is NBC.
Plus the choice of 10 other special sizes at no additional cost. Now no. You can...
And Jules Jurgensen's elegantly styled ladies 14-carat white gold rectangular case with silver bar, finished dial, and matching slim tapered bracelet, furnished by Jules Jurgensen. And now our lovely Mary Crosby. And fur and fashion and elegance are blended and designed by Davini in this stroller-length coat. The soft tones of white mink with hidden matching inserts of leather, furnished by Dicker and Dicker of Beverly Hills. Thank you, Pretty Mary. And the Ventura Collection, luggage in a soft manner with digital locks and scrubbable Dura vinyl coverings and wheels on the Pullman, furnished by Ventura. Then we'll fly you and your guest on from New Orleans for a week's stay at the Newport Resort Hotel in Miami Beach, Florida. On the ocean featuring the pub restaurant, Seven Seas Lounge, tennis club, and a fishing pier. Furnished by Newport Resort Hotel.
Let's go to Monday's Pacific Squares, Nova Stars, our booth to help you with the best. We're here to ask your questions for the first time today. Our ask, Barbara Mookler, pick a star.
Mike Connors, please.
Remember Wayne Hayes, the politician who resigned from Congress after the scandal with Elizabeth Ray? Yeah,
oh,
well,
yeah.
What's Wayne Hayes doing these days?
He was my hero. What is Wayne doing these days?
Is he retired? Is he back into politics? Is he into something
else? He's looking for a new secretary.
Yeah. No, what is he doing? Is he in politics still? Is he
No,
retired?
He's not in politics. I think he's writing a book.
He's writing a book. He's out of the political scene.
I'll agree.
Nope, he was just elected to the state legislature in Ohio. They call him Comeback Hayes. With an X and a commercial word, we'll be back.
Experience the excitement of a Hollywood premiere every night with WHT, America's premier movie network, and enjoy over 20 great films every month for only $19. That's Hollywood's best for just 65 cents a day. See whole movies and nothing but whole movies, plus sports and specials. Join WHT. Call toll-free today.
Call now and get your first month free. In New York, Long Island, and Connecticut, dial 1-800-631-7800. In New Jersey, 800-672-1151.
Philip Kent is the bastard, fugitive, fighter, lover. He had a stain on his name, a price on his life, and an appointment with destiny in colonial America.
America, a man is free to rise as far and as fast as his wits and wisdom will permit.
You've been unbelievably kind to me, sir.
I can do no less for a marked man.
Don't miss part one of John Jake's powerful bestseller, The Bastard, starring Andrew Stevens, Wednesday night at 8 on 11 Alive.
You want a comfortable solution to a good night's sleep? A Magic Motion adjustable bed can help you relax. That could help relieve backache, fatigue, or just nervous tension. Magic Motion lets you choose from twin, full, queen, or king size. Plus the choice of 10 other special sizes at no additional cost. Now you can adjust to any position at the touch of a button to help you relax, raise your legs, or raise your head. Enjoy soothing, gentle massage, or be totally spoiled by your own personal heat control. The relaxing effects of heat have long been recognized by the medical profession. So if you're looking for a better way to read in bed, eat in bed, watch TV in bed, or just relax in bed, call now for your free booklet on the surprisingly affordable Magic Motion adjustable bed. Call 1-800-331-1007. That's 1-800-331-1007. The call is free. The booklet is free. That's 1-800-331-1007. Call now and see for yourself why if you had a magic motion bed, you'd be asleep by now.
Marsh, your turn.
Antonio Fargas.
Experts say that of all the discoveries and inventions in the history of man, the four greatest are said to be speech, fire, agriculture, and what?
The wheel.
The wheel.
I agree.
The wheel. Yay. All right. Barbara?
Mary Crosby, the block, please.
Mary, your series is called Brothers and Sisters, and it's on another network. What nights are you on, dear?
It's on Friday, NBC.
Oh, it's on NBC. Well, it could be another network by the time this is shown.
After that?
It's on NBC. That's probably why I didn't know about it. just kidding, Freddie. Say, if you're the average American, how many years will you spend in school?
16. I'll agree.
Now, you're counting the 4 years of college. No, the average is 12. Oh. The average American has 12 years of schooling just out of high school. And you can't put it next to a Marshall after and that yourself.
Mary Crosby.
For $400 and the championship, true or false, Queen Elizabeth's son-in-law was recently seen leaving a novelty store after buying bags of laxative tea, sneezing powder, and a cushion with a hand that shoots up between the victim's legs. Queen Elizabeth's son-in-law. Is that true or false?
Sure, why not?
Sure, why not?
I agree.
It was Captain Mark Phillips. He's done it again. It's true. Yeah, X gets the square. Carolyn was the secret square, and tomorrow it'll be worth $7,000. Barbara, you have the beautiful necklace that you're wearing this morning. You won it $400 in cash. You picked a good week to be on, $900 in party gifts.
Ooh,
thank you, dear. Barbara Mokler, bye-bye. Congratulations. Plus, one time, 10 stars, 9 envelopes. Win yourself $5,000 in cash. It's up there somewhere.
I'll try Jane Kennedy.
Would you read the envelope, Jane?
No, I have it. Let me see.
I hope so. That'd be fun. Do you watch her, our sportscast?
Oh, yes, I do all the time.
Yeah.
Well, well, well. Close your eyes. Imagine you're in Paris. Do you hear the violins? Open your eyes. You're not in Paris. You heard the violins on your new stereo.
Oh, that's nice. Well, you can imagine you're in Paris. Great. We have a new Miss Circle. Hi there.
Hi.
A claims calculator.
Right.
What is a claims calculator?
I calculate claims for the employees of another company.
Aha. Uh-huh. You are a sports enthusiast, and you watch Jane Kennedy, obviously. Yeah. This is Diana Horner.
Right.
Good to see you, Diana. Good luck on the show. Pick a star.
Foster Brooks.
According to Ask Andy... According to Ask Andy, it's a column, Ask Andy.
Yes.
Have scientists found any purpose at all for the appendix?
One.
One?
It prevents infection.
He said, yeah.
Appendix. It prevents infection.
Yes, they have found a purpose for the appendix.
I disagree.
They have found none whatsoever.
Well, they didn't tell me that.
What a circle there. Good start. All right, good story.
Mary Crosby.
It was the very first phonograph record ever made. The very first phonograph record ever made. Now, you know a lot about phonograph records. Your daddy, I guess, sold more than anybody. Was it America the Beautiful? Was it an aria from Paiacci, or was it Mary Had a Little Lamb?
It was Mary Had a Little Lamb.
Mary Had a Little Lamb.
I disagree.
Yep, and it was recorded by Tom Edison himself. You're doing wonderfully well.
I don't believe it.
Diana?
John McCook.
According to the Harris Survey, out of every 10 Americans, how many are overweight out of 10?
Men and women. It's not men or. It's men and women.
Right.
Out of every 10, 8.
8.
I disagree.
6. We have a commercial. Circle gets the score. We'll be back.
picture taking doesn't have to cost a lot of money anymore. Now, 15-cent Photo Company offers photos for just 15 cents each from your 110, 126, or 35-millimeter film. Just 15 cents each printed on Kodak paper, and you get them fast. Put your film in any envelope plus your name, address, and payment of 15 cents a photo. That's 12 photos for $1.80, 20 for $3, 24 for $3.60. And mail it to 15 Cent Photo, Clifton, New Jersey. 15 Cent Photo, Clifton, New Jersey.
Hi, that guy from Apex Tech, at it again, telling you to call us, get into our training program for auto mechanics. Next time you see a mechanic at work, ask him where he learned his trade. And don't be surprised if he says Apex.
I learned auto mechanics at Apex Technical School. Now I do the kind of work I always wanted to do.
2.5 years ago, I graduated my course at Apex Technical School. And now I have my own shop.
Hey, how about you? How about joining the Apex Mechanic Training Program? Call us. We won't send a salesman out. We'll invite you to come in, look over our shops, look at our job placement records, and talk about qualifications for financial assistance during your training. Now, I can't phone you. To get the information, you have to take the first step. Give us a call now. 265-8100. Our switchboard is open right now. 265-8100.
For information about tickets to the Las Vegas Hollywood Squares, write to Hollywood Squares, Riviera Hotel, Post Office Box 14520, Las Vegas, Nevada 89114. Some of our celebrities have been guests of the Riviera Hotel, enjoying deluxe accommodations and exciting entertainment at the home of superstar talent such as Dolly Parton, Barry Manilow, Waylon Jennings, Liza Minnelli, and Neil Sedaka. Some travel arrangements have been provided by Pacific Southwest Airlines, PSA, your low-fare airline. PSA can fly to California, Arizona, Nevada, Utah, or Mexico. At PSA, our smiles aren't just painted on. Promotional consideration provided by Dome Home. Bring the outdoors inside with the design flexibility of the Dome and get energy efficiency, dramatic interior freedom, cost-effective construction, and greater utilization of space. From Domes America, Clarendon Hills, Illinois. The following have paid and or furnished prizes to the production company for these announcements. The Pook Pathfinder, the deluxe lightweight 10-speed bicycle, the do-everything bike for fun or serious exercise, provides transportation for the entire family, furnished by Pook. And His and Her Pelican trailers, designed for all types of bicycles, exclusive quick hitch assembly for ease and stability, lightweight yet rugged, doubles as a convenient hand cart or wheelbarrow. The Pelican, available through bicycle shops everywhere. And Mitsubishi's projection television with 50-inch diagonal screen, featuring time and channel display on screen, remote control, automatic color lock, and clock timer to preset on and off times as you choose, furnished by Mitsubishi. Plus, the dependable screw drive Genie garage door opener system, pioneered by Alliance. Demand the best, demand a Genie, only by Alliance. And look younger with Vidal Sassoon Skincare. Three simple steps for softer, smoother skin. Today and tomorrow, too, Vidal Sassoon Skincare. If you don't look good, we don't look good. Also, Brock's Old Fashioned Candy Store Taste, your real chocolate, fresh, good-tasting ingredients. Brock's the Candy Store Candy. Plus, new Tidy Bowl 4-month automatic bowl cleaner. Safely works to clean and deodorize your toilet bowl. Tidy Bowl 4 fights stains, rust, and bowl ring buildup. And Simon Eye Super Poly, the do-it-yourself poly job that outbeads, outshines, and outlasts the leading professionally applied poly treatment. Simon Eye Super Poly. And the new home version of the Hollywood Squares. Limousine service for guests of Hollywood Squares provided by Sims Limousine Service.
What's your turn?
Carol Lindley.
According to the San Francisco Chronicle, when do most people make love on a regular basis? Is it in the afternoon, in the middle of the night, or at 10:35 p.m.?
Did you say when or where?
No, I said when do most people make love on a regular basis? In the afternoon, in the middle of the night, or 10:35 p.m.?
I would say at 10:35 p.m.
I would agree with you.
I guess 25 Dough minutes of the late is. News, right. Yeah, that's it. Uh-huh. Yeah. You've got the X, and it's your turn, yeah. Diana.
Mike Connors.
According to a university study, Michael, who's more likely to be seen walking in a porno, into a porno movie? A young, educated guy or a dirty old man?
That's a tough question. I've never done a porno movie. I've been asked, but I just couldn't get up to doing it. I would... I would say, the young educated men that I know.
A young educated guy.
I agree.
Yeah, a young educated guy. Mm-hmm. All righty. Your turn, boys.
Antonio Fargas.
Antonio.
Yes.
Is frizzy hair in or out these days? Frizzy hair, is it in or out?
Well, the last time I was at the beauty shop, no, it's got to be, the afro is out, but the frizz hair is in.
Frizzy is in.
Frizzy hair is in, I agree.
Frizzy hair is in. Well, I'm out. Yes. Diana, go right ahead, dear.
Jane Kennedy.
Jane, this would be for $200. According to a recent study, how many lovers have most women had before they marry their husbands?
Do we ask the best man that? let me see.
How many lovers have most women had before they married?
I would say none.
None.
I disagree.
One. Men have had 2 to 5, by the way. And we have $200 for Diana Horner. Congratulations. We'll pick a star.
Foster Brooks.
A true or false, a camel in Southern California's wild animal park got all hot and bothered one day and tried to mate with a visiting Volkswagen.
Well, if it'll work, they'd have had a camel that could go 48 hours in the desert without gas.
But could a camel escape from a wild animal park and try to mate with a visiting Volkswagen? Is that true or false?
That is false.
That's false.
Sounds ridiculous, but I'll disagree.
When it's time for a camel to mate, it's time. It's true also. We have the X, and Diana, it's your turn.
Mary Crosby.
Mary, according to the book The Perfect Exercise, this exercise has been called the shortest way possible to a beautiful body. What exercise is it?
I wish I knew. Well, it's got to be the sit-up.
Sit-ups.
I disagree.
It's jumping rope. There is no exercise you can spend less time on and get more results than jumping rope with a circle. And Morris, your turn.
John McCook.
What? Now, you're on Young and Restless. How many years have you been on that?
Almost 4 now.
All right. It's a big popular show. Mm-hmm. What popular soap opera begins with, like the sand through an hourglass, so are the days of our lives? What show is that?
What show is that? You just said it.
What?
The Days of Our Lives.
The Days of Our Lives.
I agree.
With McDonald Carey. Yes, uh-huh. Saying that. Diana?
I don't have
Carol
to listen
Lindley.
To that.
It's true or false. According to the book, The Loudest Screen Kiss, the loudest screen kiss in movie history took place between Jack Palance and Shelley Winters.
Well, I've done movies with both of them, so I know. The loudest screen kiss
ever recorded took place between Jack Palance and Shelley Winters.
I would love to say yes, but I really don't think so.
You said that's false.
I agree.
No, in the movie I Died a Thousand Times. That was the loudest screen kiss ever recorded. Yes.
Loud as a noise?
I would imagine so. Uh-huh.
Instead of screaming.
Yes, we have a commercial. We'll be back. I was definitely with the camel in the Volkswagen.
How did I get this great career? It all started the day I enrolled at this school, Technical Career Institute.
I wanted really good skills.
And they gave me a choice of color TV servicing, computers and automation, air conditioning and refrigeration.
So if top-notch skills are what you're after, come see us.
These are just a few of our many fine TCI people. This free TCI career booklet gives you the full story on how you may become one of them. So call 246-5100 now.
Hi, I'm John Shuck, Daddy Warbucks of Annie, here with Sandy at the North Shore Animal League in nearby Port Washington, Long Island. You can adopt your Sandy today or any of the hundreds of free dogs, free cats, valuable field breeds, puppies, or kittens. North Shore Animal League gives you free collars, leashes, food, and even pays for your gas to get there and back when you adopt. North Shore Animal League is open every day till 10 p.m., even Saturday and Sunday. For directions, call area code 516-883-7575. That's 883-7575.
Morris, your turn.
Carol Lindley.
For $600 and a tie game, you're on a cruise ship. What should you tip that young cabin boy every time he does a little favor for you?
$20?
$20.
Yeah? Depends how big the favor is.
She said $20.
I disagree.
Boy, would I love to do some favors for you, Carol. I'll tell you. No, 50 cents. Every
50
time he
cents.
Does something, 50 cents.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. We have a tiger. That's
I
nice. That's just the square. Let's pull in the board. Diane, pick a star.
Foster Brooks.
We all know Abe Lincoln was born in a log cabin. You knew that, didn't you?
Oh, yes.
What state was it in?
A mess.
No, I don't mean the log cabin. What state of the Union was Honest Abe born?
Where was President Lincoln born?
Right, that's the question.
In my home state, and you know what that is, Kentucky.
I agree.
Yeah, the family moved to Illinois later, and that is your state. I know that. I played on your golf tournament. It was Kentucky. Okay, Morris, your turn.
Mary Crosby.
Do the majority of Americans use our seatbelts?
No.
No.
And they should.
I agree.
Well, no, we don't. And yes, we should. We're the next. Diana, your turn.
John McCook.
In the fairy tale, how long did Sleeping Beauty sleep? How many years?
How many years? Whoa. Sleeping Beauty slept. She looked wonderful, I remember, when she woke up, so it couldn't have been. She looked wonderful. 2 years.
2 years.
I disagree.
100 years.
You know, right?
Yes, all right. Morris, your turn.
Carol Lindley.
Carol, according to the University of Illinois research, who will make the most faithful mate? The most faithful mate? A man that admires legs, bosoms, or derrieres?
That's quite a choice. Man who would make the most faithful mate, I think, would be a leg man.
Legs?
Yes.
I disagree.
No, men who admire women's bottoms are found to be the most dependable and faithful. We have the X there, and Diana, your turn. According to the proverb, Paul, what shouldn't you do? What shouldn't you do against a stone wall?
What Billy Carter did.
What shouldn't you do against a stone wall, according to the proverb?
Well, a whale.
Cry. Whale. Diana?
I disagree.
Beat Good. Your head. Don't beat your head against a stone wall. Yeah. Already, your turn. Morris?
Mike Connors.
Michael, in criminal slang, what's a five-finger discount?
A five-finger discount in criminal slang?
In criminal slang? That's what you guys, you and Mannix.
Five-finger... sounds like the examination when you go in.
Morris?
I disagree.
No, something stolen. Yes. Diana, your turn.
Antonio Fargas.
For the championship at $400, according to experts, will you get better gas mileage in your car with the windows rolled up or the windows rolled down? Better mileage.
Well, that's got to be a resistance problem. If you have the windows open, there's got to be more resistance, so you get...
Better mileage. More. Up or down?
Better mileage. Up.
Up.
I agree.
It cuts down on wind resistance, a commercial, and we have a new champion, Diana Horner.
Now you can put an end to leaking pipes. Permanently seal cracks in walls and foundations quickly, easily, and for just a small fraction of what a professional would charge. Thanks to Leak Sealer, the super effective all-purpose sealant. Leak Sealer is always ready to use. All you do is just shake, point, and spray. Just watch. We'll take this household strainer, spray it with all-purpose Leak Sealer, and look, not a drop of water comes through. It's been completely sealed, watertight. Leak Sealer works on any surface. It's perfect for all kinds of household repair jobs, both indoors and out. Leak Sealer will not crack, peel, or become brittle. You can even paint right over it. It seals tightly at all temperatures, and because it's weather resistant, it lasts. So start saving hundreds of dollars with all-purpose Leak Sealer. The easy, quick way to seal cracks and leaks. Satisfaction guaranteed, or return it to place of purchase for full refund.
All-purpose Leak Sealer quickly seals any leak or crack.
Only $4.95, available at all Woolco, Woolworth, Rite Aid Centers, and Genevieve's Drugstore.
Let's go to work on your future. Let's work to make things clear. You supply the drive, we supply the skills to arrive at a great career.
At Taylor Business Institute, we offer career training in business management and secretarial science. For information, call 245-6666. 245-6666.
If you work on your future, the future's going to work.
Have your fling in the spring at Mount Airy Lodge or Pocono Gardens. Beautiful rooms, fabulous food, headline entertainment. Winter, spring, summer, fall, call 966-7210 for reservations at Pocono Gardens and...
Morris, we have lovely party gifts for you, about $1,700 in gifts. You stay right there. Time is up. Have a good day. See you here tomorrow for more fun on the Hollywood Squares. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Today's party contestant receives Samsonite's Expression Group 2 folding table and chairs, versatile and handsome for any room in your home. You can decorate a whole new room with Expression folding furniture furnished by Samsonite. Plus, the Insinkerator trash compactor, plus the H2O steaming tap that gives you 190-degree water at your kitchen sink for instant foods, furnished by ISE. And light and easy, the lightweight iron from General Electric handles the same ironing jobs as the heavier iron. Also, Celebrity Fashion Jewels offers the assortment of pieces to go with every wardrobe and every taste preference. Celebrity looks just beautiful on you. Plus, colorful DuPont Lucite spray paint. The quick and easy way to add fresh new decorative touches all around your home with Lucite spray paint. You color it easy. And paperback books from Signet featuring Glinda by Susan Lee, a firestorm romance that only the author of Winterfire could have created. Also, the Wherever Chicken Bucket low-pressure fryer makes chicken crispy and juicy like takeout in minutes. Great for other fried foods, too. The Chicken Bucket by Wherever. Plus, Theragran high-potency vitamins supplied to the U.S. Olympic Committee and the vitamins most recommended by physicians and pharmacists. Theragran and Theragran M with minerals. And Jazzy Fashion by Happy Legs. Style to fit a woman's figure in a junior style. Young thinking fashion, Missy Styles, furnished by Happy Legs.
Made by a company that cares, fitted by a specialist who cares. Look for your Fleet Air Specialist in the April 3rd issue of Woman's Day magazine.
Mystery and Suspense on Mrs. Columbo, Thursday night at 10. High Rollers! And here's the man with the action, Alex Trebek.
Thank you, Kenny. Hi, welcome to High Rollers. I want you to meet our players. Lady in red, she's a tournament backgammon player from Los Angeles. Her name is Candace Maron. And our champion, a flight attendant from Marina Del Rey, originally from Manchester, England, Pearl Kelly. Welcome back, ladies. Our champion, Pearl, has won just a shade over $10,000. Up to this point, $10,106, and she leads in the current match. She won the first game on our last program, and now we begin game number two. We've got one column up there that is chock full of prizes, so that means we're putting two prizes up on the board, and here comes the first of those. We got some very attractive prizes. Let's see what we add to them right now.
It's Riviera.
Richards Island Work Center with cutlery divider, cutting board, and bread storage, featuring solid oak construction, hand-rubbed finish, and butcher block top, furnished by Riviera Kitchen. And with it, Miracle-Made cookware with exclusive abrasion-resistant gem coat exterior and sparkling Miracle interior, and fully automatic Vectromade countertop cooker, complete with carving board and serving tray, furnished by Miracle-Made.
Cook Center in the middle for $2,693. In keeping with our theme of barefoot in the kitchen, pregnant, this prize.
A variety of Strolly quality products for your baby's safety and comfort, including strollers, car seat, high chair, and portable bassinet. Furnished by Strolly of California. And Selecta Photo Murals assortment of murals, including this one of Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, especially for children. There's one to fit almost any wall in your home or office, furnished by Selecta Photo Murals.
The baby things, the mural in column number one, $2,677. And as I pointed out a few moments ago, we have one column that has five prizes in it. Five prizes, including a vacation in Mexico, in Mazatlan, a lovely city, and another one in Las Vegas. $5,496. That's the value there. Are you ready to go today, Candy?
Yes, I certainly am.
You know what you have to do. You have to win two games in a row if you want to become our champion.
Right.
Pearl has to win only one. Here we go. Let's bring the numbers in. 1, 2, 9, 7, 8, 4, 3, 6, and 5. The first column, then, with a roll of 8. Think about that and the combinations that will clear that first column. And while you are doing that, we will have these commercial messages for you folks at home.
I feel good all under. Know why I feel good all under? My Hanes underwear fits all under. Look, reinforced neck, double seams, and a waistband that doesn't dig in. What comfort. The Hanes price makes my wallet feel good, too. Boy, do I feel good all under.
Hanes makes you feel good all under.
Good morning. Good
morning.
Let Hanes make him feel good all under.
Welcome to the cold and flu season. You felt a cold or flu coming on this morning. Now you're really achy and feverish. Take Bayer aspirin. For aches and fever, what's in Bayer is what doctors recommend most. 100% pure aspirin, nothing more. That's what's in Bayer aspirin. And millions have used Bayer with no stomach upset. So remember, rest, fluids, and Bayer aspirin. For aches and fever, what's in Bayer is what doctors recommend most.
Both of our contestants have their hands on the buzzer, so let's go to work. Betty Davis, Betty Ford, Betty Comden. Who spells her first name with two E's? Pearl.
Davis.
Davis is right. You got it. You take the dice. Every morning, you roll first.
Yes.
Getting to be a habit with you, Pearl. No roll. No roll. They've got both dice have to lie flat on the table. As Candy would say, double sixes. Good news, no matter where you are. There's the insurance marker for the two sixes. Now, let's see what we can do. Can we clear a column? No, we can't.
I think 9. Okay, 7-5. Yes.
7-5 combination. We want to open that third column because it's the most valuable one. The dipsomaniac, the kleptomaniac, the nymphomaniac. Which one is very, very... Candy?
The first one.
Very, very fond of men. No, not the dipsomaniac.
The dipsomaniac
will steal men. The nymphomaniac is very, very fond of them. Pearl, you have control of the dice. There are no bad numbers. Roll.
The way I like it. Here comes an 8. Double 4.
11.
9-2.
You can clear a column. 9-2 will clear the third.
9-2, yes.
You were wondering there for a moment. I said a moment ago, and I was caught by my producer. I made a mistake. Bad mistake.
Why?
I said a dipsomaniac would steal. A kleptomaniac is the one who steals. Dipsomaniac hits the sauce. I wanted to stay away from that subject for obvious reasons. Barbara Streisand, Bobby Gentry, Roberta Flack. Which one sang the hit song Ode to Billy Joe? Yes, Pearl.
Billy Gentry. Bobby Gentry.
Bobby Gentry. I think we can accept that. Yes, we had Barbara, Bobby, and Roberta. We had no Billy, so we'll take it from you. You got half her name right. And at the moment, there are no bad rolls.
That's the way I like it.
So no danger
that's
to
sure
you.
There comes an 8. Double 4.
It's 7. 6-1, 3-4.
6-1.
Six and one. Which can you see through clearly? Something that is transparent or... Candace?
Transparent.
Yes, not translucent. 5, 6, 9, and 10 are bad.
I think I'll pass the dice.
Pearl, no danger. You have an insurance marker in front of you.
Here comes a seven.
Oh, here comes an eight. And it's a double. There you go, Pearl. The eight is automatic. It clears the middle column. 2,693. The elephant, the cook center, all the pots and pans. So far in the second, and what may turn out to be the deciding game of the match, if Pearl continues the way she's going, you've got about $7,000-$8,000 in prizes on your side. Candace, you've got to work hard now.
I want the elephant.
Mike Douglas, Kirk Douglas, Melvin Douglas. Who is the father of...
Kirk Douglas.
Kirk Douglas is the father of the Streets of San Francisco star, Michael Douglas. You're right, you have control. And Candace, you know how it is in backgammon when you need a 3-4. That's what you need. 3-4. 5-0. Sorry about that. Pearl, you've won the game, the match, and all these prizes. Candace will not get her elephant today. The cooking center, the holiday in Mexico. One in Las Vegas, the bar, the brass bed, and the ice box, and you now have a total of $18,295. Congratulations to you. Big numbers coming up in a moment. Candace, you gave her a good shot in a, as you know from your experiences in backgammon, in a short series.
The role is everything.
The role is everything. Anything can happen. Good having you with
us
on the program. We have some parting gifts for you backstage.
Thank you.
Take care. Do I want these? I think I should have these insurance markers back. No, you can't. You know you can't carry these over into... Only asking, you know. Did you catch that, folks? Trying to just slip by the old devil here. All right, let's bring the numbers up. And once again, I will point out that if Pearl gets them all off the board, she wins this lovely prize.
Buick's new Skyhawk with a compact, even-firing V6 engine for smooth, economical power, overall sporty styling and comfort. Skyhawk, furnished by Buick.
A $5,000 car, we match it with the same amount in cash for a $10,000 payoff, if you can do it. If I recall correctly, on your last attempt, you got seven numbers off. All you have to do is better that by two. You shall? Good. I believe you, Pearl. Millions would doubt, but I believe. The first roll is a four.
Just a four.
The four comes off. I believe, Pearl. Go.
Good. Doubles. Big doubles.
Ten. Good roll.
Nine and one.
300. That's what you have so far.
Okay, more doubles.
Doubles. She wants to get to seven. That is good. I believe, Pearl.
Good.
Seven again. Five and two is automatic.
Five, two.
Three, six, and eight. I still believe, Pearl. Four.
No.
I am becoming a non-believer, Pearl.
Oh.
But you did pick up $600, and that's $600 more than you had a few moments ago. So you go to $18,895 as we flash it on the board. And I think that was a beautiful understatement on your part. Quite nice. 18,895. Quite nice, thank you. Let's see who we've got now. Another English accent coming out. Linda?
We have an insurance adjuster from Culver City. His name is Jim Day.
Hello, Jim.
Hello, Jerry.
Good to have you here. Our champion, have you met him?
Yeah, looking good.
An insurance adjuster.
Yes.
Automobile or other things?
No, first party property.
Ah. All right, good to have you here. We're going to get into the game in the way of adding prizes and putting the numbers on the board and starting off with the questions, but first we have to take a break. Pay the rent on the studio with these commercial messages.
You know how important a moisturizer is to a woman's skin. It helps keep it from drying and cracking. Helps maintain its natural beauty.
Now, watch how Old English Furniture Polish works the same way on your wood furniture.
Old English's blend of three moisturizing ingredients helps keep the finish from drying and cracking. Helps preserve its natural beauty. It does for your furniture what your moisturizer does for your skin.
Old English, the moisturizer, helps preserve the natural beauty of your furniture. In pump spray, too.
Psoriasis, there's no real cure. But for superior relief of itching, redness, scaling, use Oxapore. relieves itch in red scaling areas on contact. It contains an anti-itch ingredient unique among psoriasis remedies. Compared clinically for 28 days, Oxipor reduced about twice as much of the red scaling area as Tegrin. Oxipor, far stronger in the leading anti-scaling ingredient and not greasy. Oxipor relieves itch on contact, reduces about twice the red scaling area as Tegrin.
Psst, hey, lady.
Huh?
Want to make a better salad?
A better salad?
Try Bako's.
Oh, I've tried bacon bits before.
These?
Oh, I...
Bako's taste better. Tests prove that people like Bako's in salads even better than any leading real bacon bits.
Mmm, they do taste better.
Pour on the flavor.
That's using your head.
Make a better salad with Bako's. Make a better salad today. Cheerio!
Made from oats, the cereal grain highest in protein, fortified with 8 vitamins and iron, and golden toasted to make it a tasty part of your family's complete breakfast.
Cheerio! Cheerio! Cheerio!
A few moments ago, I mentioned prizes. That's the way we start every game, by adding some beautiful items to our prize board over there. Here's what's going in first.
It's a washer and dryer. Whirlpool's large capacity automatic washer with water and energy saving selectors, double duty agitator and self-cleaning filter. Also, a matching clothes dryer with custom dry control and hamper door, furnished by Whirlpool Corporation.
The washer dryer into the first column. The value goes up to $3,317. Now something very useful for those cold nights here in Southern Cal.
Chinook's quality freestanding fireplace stove. All stainless steel firebox for rapid heat transfer. Approved for use in conventional, mobile, or modular homes. Furnished by Chinook. And a pair of Burris recliners. These beautiful chairs not only recline with a touch to a full lounging position, but also rock and swivel. Furnished by Burris.
Your rocking and swiveling chairs and fireplace in the middle. $1,321. Now let's keep you well dressed.
Here's Linda with Luigi Fashions Limited slightly A-line skirt and the new shorter length. Silk stitching, detailed side pockets, worn under the softly tailored coat, all in luscious ultra suede. Furnished by Luigi Fashions Limited. And here's Becky in Victor Costa's lovely three-piece outfit, featuring a short quilted vest worn over a soft blouse and matched with a new intermission length skirt with border trim. Furnished by Victor Costa.
$1,000 in ladies' fashions for... column number three. Jim, we didn't learn in our introduction whether you were single or married.
I'm single.
Aha. What would you do with $1,000 in ladies' fashions, were you to win it?
I don't know, but I think I'd get some calls.
Good thinking. The man's got the right idea. Let's bring in the numbers. First column, very attractive right off the bat. A 1, 3, 5, a roll of 9. Third column, well, a roll of 12. Thank you for pointing that out. Sometimes I don't catch everything. The Turkish call it kismet. Do we call it sex, humor, or fate? Kismet.
Humor.
No, we call it fate. That's what kismet is. Pearl, you take them, and once again, at the beginning of a match,
double,
you're
six,
the first one to roll.
Yes.
Nine. Nine is excellent. Look carefully at the first column. Look at the first column. That's it. 5, 3, 1. Don't look anywhere else. $3,317. Baccarat, Barracuda. Which one could give you a nasty bite?
Barracuda.
Barracuda, yes. You got it, Jim? 3 and 5 are bad. Everything else is okay.
She can have them.
She can have them. Well, Pearl's going to try to roll a 12 right now. Get an insurance marker and clear the third column. 9. No, that's not a 10. That's a 9. A 5 and a 4, Pearl.
The 9.
9? All right. John Ehrlichman, John Dean, H.R. Haldeman. Which of these Watergate figures is newly married? Caught you there, not fast enough. On November 3rd, 1978, John Ehrlichman got married. Sheridan Casper Laramie. Three of the biggest towns in what state?
Kansas.
No, Wyoming. Casper.
It's my weak subject in school.
Geography?
Cities.
Cities. Ah, these were towns.
Oh, okay.
Pearl, you have control of the deck.
Can I have that opportunity, huh?
Okay.
Okay, we
only
want...
three and a five to avoid.
15?
No. Okay. Roll 12. Double
12,
six.
Boxcars.
Whoa, look at it go. That one is now in Casper, Wyoming. I'll bring the other one back. Give you a choice here. Pick one of the two. That
okay.
one? Roll again.
Okay, boxcars, here we go.
Still trying to avoid a three or a five, and he rolls a seven, which is good.
I'll take the seven.
Think of the comic Gabe Kaplan and tell me, is that a real mustache or a phony?
Real.
Jim, it's real, you're right.
She's got him.
Pearl has it. Pearl, if you look at the board, you will see that we have a lot of even numbers, so you need an even roll.
Even numbers.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, or 12. 9 is not even. That means Jim Day's got the first game. Congratulations. As Jim Neighbors would have said, surprise, surprise, surprise.
Cease to amaze us.
Yeah, well, you're halfway to winning the match, getting a shot at $10,000 with the big numbers. And at the moment, we return $3,300 in beautiful prizes from this board to that first column, $3,317. And we start adding immediately as we prepare for game number two. We've got room for three prizes going in. Look over here for the first one.
It's a giant screen TV.
It's Smartronics, 100% solid state. Screen designed for easy care with a clear, sharp picture. Comes in a beautiful cabinet furnished by Smartronics. That prize we put in the middle. The value goes to 2,316. Next, this.
It's an elegant Jaeger LeCoultre man's watch. Features an 18-karat gold casing, Roman numeral symbols, and a black lizard band. Compliments of high rollers. And this music box will keep your watch in style. It's lustrous wood, simple and elegant lines, perfect for dresser or table, furnished by Altschul & Sons.
A full house. Five prizes in column one, 3,847, and a prize worth at least that much now.
The Marantz reproducing piano using computerized cassette tapes automatically records and plays live piano performances with the precise touch and expression of the original recording artist. Furnished by Marantz.
$4,000 piano into column three, bringing the value to $4,995. Do either one of you play the piano? The great thing and the bad thing about this piano is that it will reproduce exactly what you play. So if you're a lousy player, don't switch it on. Let's bring in the numbers. Third column, someone says, and they're absolutely right. The three, the two, and the four, the roll will be a niner. Johnson, Kennedy, Eisenhower, who was president during the Cuban Missile?
Kennedy.
Kennedy was president, you're absolutely right.
Okay,
everything is
we
good.
Need a nine. Come on, big nine. Let's go.
That's a nine. It gets a three instead.
I'll take that three.
Take the three off the upper right-hand corner, and we'll come back and continue this match right after we take a break for this commercial message. That's what the music is all about.
When perky peas are what you please,
put them under Mrs. Fiddleburn.
When you want toast to be the most,
put it under Mrs. Fiddleburn.
Or carrots, green beans, waffles, or rice,
to make potatoes specially nice.
In cooking, baking, don't think twice,
put it under Mrs. Fiddleburn.
No matter what you put under Mrs. Fiddleburn's margarine, the flavor comes out on top.
Sorry, guys, but I can't drive home.
This better be good.
Well, I had a sinus headache, and my sinus medicine made me kind of drowsy.
Next time, try Sinaid. Sinaid relieves sinus pressure and sinus pain, yet Sinaid won't make you drowsy.
Let's go!
You sure look chipper today.
Oh, I wasn't. I had another sinus headache. But this time, I took Sinaid, and I'm not drowsy.
Sinaid puts your sinus headache to sleep, not you.
Our story opens on the Duke of Cheddar holding court.
So, caught stealing my Cheetos, were you?
He can't speak, sire. His mouth's full of Cheetos.
Those are real Cheetos, baby.
He says the real cheese taste made him do it, sire.
Poor bloke. He loves the real cheese taste. Let him eat a few Cheetos.
Nothing doing. Cheetos are fit for a king.
Since when are you a king, Duke? Here, love.
Mm-hmm. Cheetos brand cheese flavored snacks, a wealth of real cheese taste.
In fashion, the news is the shirt dress. And that's the news at Sears. Dresses in real men's shirting for only $17.99. Your choice of checks, plaids, stripes, with your choice of styles. While quantities last, the shirt dress. Only $17.99 and only at Sears, the fashion place.
All right, here we go. We continue the game. He was on In the Beginning earlier this season, and now he's back on television with Hello, Larry. Is he Joe Namath, Lauren Green, or McLean Stevenson? Pearl.
McLean Stevenson.
McLean is the right answer. Yes. Nothing is bad.
I like to hear that. A six. Okay.
A six.
Four and two,
of course. $1,000 in Milady's fashions and the reproducing piano.
Right.
A star, a planet, or a quark? What is the sun? Pearl.
Planet. No.
Pearl, you know immediately you said the wrong thing.
I
the
do.
Sun is, of course, a star. Jim has control of the dice. Three and four are bad. Everything else is all right. You're leading in the match. You've got
she
a game.
She can have the dice.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
Try and roll a double. Help your cause. Open up the board. A double gets a nine, which is a good roll. Take an eight and one. Take a nine.
I'll take the nine.
Take the nine. We've opened the middle column. Your upper chest or your lower back? Which is your lumbar region?
Upper.
Lumbar. If you had my back, you would know where that's your lumbar so region is. Lower back. All right, Pearl, you have control of the dice.
I will pass.
Three bad rolls right
I shall
now.
Pass the dice.
3, 4, and 10 are to be avoided like the plague, Jim.
All right, let's go. Come on, we need a 11. 11, here we go, 11.
7 is good. Two ways. 7 or 61.
I'll take that 7.
7 comes out. Does it measure altitude, wind speed, or time if it's a chronometer?
Wind speed.
No, it measures time, a chronometer. Pearl has control of the dice.
I will pass again.
Passing again. Jim, same bad rolls as before. 3, 4, and 10.
Anything but a 3, 4, 10.
3 is bad. Pearl, you've tied the match, and in tying it up, you've won some prizes. Congratulations. Took a little while, but you did it. You've got $1,000 in ladies' fashions and the piano, and your total goes above $20,000. You now have $23,890. And for the first time, I think for the first time in about a week, we're going into a tiebreaker game, the third and deciding game of a match. Usually we have a player rolling along very nicely, winning two in a row, but that's not the case. So for game number three in this match, we have two prizes to add. First of all, something to brighten up your life.
Capturing the look of nature, these two lamps are made of Italian cast acrylic with leaf and plant pattern, each with its silk shade, valued at over $1,300. They're from Wallace Edwards.
The lamps go into the middle. $3,666, that's what the value is. Now this art piece.
From the Alice in Wonderland series, it's a Dolly lithograph entitled The Pool of Tears, signed and numbered by the artist from the Steve Stein Gallery.
Subtle, Becky, subtle. $600 Dolly artwork in column three. And column one, of course, $3,847 worth of five prizes, which include a holiday in Reno, and of course, the metal detector. Let us not forget the metal detector. Here come the numbers. I picked the middle. Did I do right? I did. 5, 3, and 1 at the sound of the bell. We'll figure out what that adds up to after this.
My son Charlie helps out quite a bit around here.
Charlie! Almost finished?
He always gives his best for us. So I like to do my best for him, like making his favorite, Toll House cookies.
I don't use imitation chocolate.
I use Nestle's real chocolate morsels. Charlie loves the taste of real chocolate, and I like the creaminess of Nestle's.
Anything else, Mom?
Mm-hmm. You help me eat some Toll House cookies? Nestle's real chocolate morsels.
My family's worth it.
As a children's wear buyer, I bought for thousands of kids. Now, I buy for three. But I'm as fussy as ever. That's why I love Garanimals. Oh, not just because they mix and match by matching tags, or because they look great, or because the fabrics are extra strong, or even because Garanimals' quality is so high while the prices are so low. I don't buy Garanimals for any of those reasons. I buy them for all those reasons. I know kids' clothes, I know kids, and I know value.
It's going to be a tiebreaker game when we begin our next program here on High Rollers. And these two people will be here, and hopefully we'll have the pleasure of your company also. Till then, have a good day. So long.
Today's fighting contestants receive Samsonite Barmaid Royale bar stools. The big bucket is designed to indulge you in complete comfort, featuring plush padded seats in warm earth tone colors. Barmaid Royale, furnished by Samsonite. And K-Lux decorative bricks, authentic looking with five sides of corner and custom pieces for installation without cutting. Lightweight, fireproof, economical. K-Lux furnished by KSH Incorporated. And Foster Grand sunglasses with polarized mirror and gradient lenses. Isn't that you behind those Foster Grands? Also, Toastmasters all-in-one toaster oven broiler bakes 9-inch pies, toast 4 to 6 bread slices at a time. Door opens automatically. Toastmaster plus kids' fashions from Winnie the Pooh and Sears. Spring look, colors, patterns, and matching washable fabrics of pure quality, pure delight. And colorful DuPont Lucite spray paints. The quick and easy way to add fresh new decorative touches all around your home with Lucite spray paints. You color it easy. Also, paperback books from Signet featuring Glinda by Susan Lee, a firestorm romance that only the author of Winter Fire could have created. Plus, an assortment of 12-ounce resealable wide mouth jars of Subi honey. Subi is great for spreading, sweetening, topping, baking, cooking, and canning. And Vidal Sassoon's 3 Steps to Beautiful Hair. Color safe shampoo, protein remoisturizer for conditioning and finishing rinse to seal and protect. Clean, shiny hair furnished by Vidal Sassoon.
Tomorrow night, be sure to see a special episode of Brothers and Sisters, followed by the startling conclusion of The Dark Secret of Harvest Home, starring Betty Davis, the spine-tingling drama of a family who moves to the country and finds the townspeople frightfully out of step with the times. Both tomorrow on NBC. Right now, it's Wheel of Fortune next.
This has been a Merrill Heater, Bob Quigley production.
What is the dark secret of Harvest Home?
What did you see?
A ghost?
You want me to believe that you accept this local voodoo?
What do they do?
Do you want to end up like me?
Betty Davis in a two-part chiller. The Dark Secret of Harvest Home begins tonight after cliffhangers.
The News Plus.
Plus me, Betty Furness. I'll tell you how your money can make money.
On the Lindstrom Tolliver Early Edition, weekdays at 5.
Look at this Winmore ad. Winmore, midway between Miami and Palm Beach, is Florida's most beautiful adult community. Winmore is what Florida living's all about. Sunshine, water, swaying palms, and lots of open space. More important, all those exciting Winmore activities to keep you active, secure, and happy. Find out about Winmore for yourself. Call toll-free day or night, 800-327-8985. 800-327-8985.
It's time we had a pet-to-owner chat about the litter box problem. Sure, it's easy to blame me, but it's the filler you're using. Try a new improved kitty litter with twice the odor control of any leading cat box filler, so it doesn't leave your house smelling like cat box filler. And it doesn't leave it smelling like cat box filler that's been used by a cat. New improved kitty litter leaves your house...
Look at these luxurious prizes! Fabulous merchandise, just waiting to be won today on Wheel of Fortune. A beautiful gold coin bracelet. Dining room furniture. A bumper pool table. Total retail value over $37,000. And now, here's your host, Chuck Woolery.
Fortune. I'd like to introduce our hostess, Susan Stafford. Is it you? Come on out. Hey! The basic neon blue. That blue is any hotter to be on fire. Let's take a look and see who's got here. Hey, Gwen.
How you doing, Chuck?
I'm doing fine. This is our returning champ, Gwen Taylor. She's got a one-day total of $5,500.
Wow.
Oh,
thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Brian.
Hi. How are you?
Fine.
That's good. This is Brian Schlechty, right?
Yeah.
And he's originally from Omaha, Nebraska, tennis pro,
enjoys cartooning. On the court?
No.
How do you work that out? Yeah. Where are you tennis pro?
Balboa Bay Club, Newport
Beach.
Right,
terrific. Yeah, that's great. Nice to have you with us today.
Thank you.
Hey, Anita.
Hi.
How are you, huh?
Just fine, thank you.
That's good. This is Anita Milner.
Yes.
And she's a substitute high school teacher, married, mother of two. I love substitute teachers. I can remember high school. Didn't you love it when the substitute came in? Man, you had a lot of fun. It was terrific. Yeah, nice to have you with us today.
You're the one.
Yeah, I'm the one. That's right. I always was. Let's take a look at our wheel of fortune. Top dollar value on the wheel of the first round, $500. We'll look out for this black space bankrupt. If you hit it, you lose all your cash, but not your merchandise, because once you buy a prize, it's yours to keep. Remember, when you solve the puzzle, you got to solve it just like it's revealed on this puzzle board. Right over here, we're going to take a look at that right now. This is praise. Now, just before the show, would you remember to start the game for us when you won? Here we go.
Okay.
Good luck, everybody.
Thank you.
Come on,
business. Come on.
We're off.
Come on.
$500.
Is there a tea, please?
You're trying to figure out what the hand was for, the tea, or for just asking for it?
Yeah.
Sure, you got $500.
Okay.
Got enough money to buy a valve at $250 a piece, and yes, the puzzle is filling up your options, and we're ready to roll. $150.
Okay, is there an F, please, as a stop?
Nope. No, okay. Ryan. All right.
Come on.
Everybody gets
all right, $500.
Okay, Brian. $200. I would like an N as a Nancy, please.
Yes, sir.
In the middle. $200, so your turn.
Okay, I'm gonna spin, okay?
Come on, big one. Try the four, $450. Looking at five, not enough juice, gonna make three, maybe. You got it?
A D, please.
Yeah.
Gonna be
$500, know your options,
okay.
So your turn.
I'd like to buy a vowel.
Okay.
And A?
Yes, there are two of them. This is a phrase, Brian.
Turn all right, I'll spin.
Okay. Out of five, once, twice, and look at a two. Hello, two.
Okay, I would like an R, please.
Oh, yeah, three of those. Four. Welcome to R City. $1,050
okay.
Is a phrase.
I'll spin.
Okay, good luck. Big one. Three span territory coming up. Be way by that. Maybe make that 400. Can you make it?
Come on.
You got it. $400. Letter, please.
I would like an L, please.
Yes, sir. Can you solve it?
I'll solve it.
$1,450 if you can.
Trial and error.
All yours. Yeah. Not only a tennis pro, he's smart and a snappy dresser, too. $1,450 family room, what are you going to buy?
I would like the grandfather clock, please.
Yeah, $749. Those are really nice. They just make a house feel like a home, you know? You're ticking all over the house. $701.
For $595, I'd like the bumper pool table, please.
Just look like the athletic type, you know?
Yeah, I'll take that.
All right. How much? $106, okay.
$106, I'll take the dartboard and darts.
You're going to be busy.
Rest on 90.
Giorgio gift certificate.
Gift certificate,
yeah. $13 will give you a cup of coffee. Here's Charlie O'Donnell to take back your stuff. Charlie?
You bet, Chuck. Your family can enjoy the traditionally English game of darts with this fine dartboard cabinet. An old English inn sign on the face of the cabinet, double doors open to expose dartboard and chalkboards for scorekeeping. Retail value, $93. This bumper pool table is constructed from solid mahogany and a light old world finish. It features a genuine slate top and comes with balls, cue sticks, repair kit, and rule book. Furnished by Golden West Billiards, retail value $595. And Pearl's beautiful grandfather clock, featuring an imported weight-driven movement, full Westminster chimes, and a hardwood furniture cabinet with traditional craftsmanship. Furnished by Pearl Grandfather Clocks, retail value $749.
Look over here, the clock is looking primo, you know? That's a different clock. That is all right. We're going to come back around to him in a hand. Good. Welcome back to round two of Wheel of Fortune. Top dollar value on the wheel for this round, $1,000. We've got another bankrupt, and I'm taking a little longer because we've got a great big puzzle right over here. Everybody turn around, look at that. Quotation. Brian, you got the first shot at it. Look at that one.
All right.
Here we go.
Come on, big one. Come on, thousand.
By the nine. Whoa.
Now's the time to do it, boy. I'll tell you that. I need it for you. No money involved. Come on, Rita finally gets to step up the batter's box. She got it. Come on, Rita.
Dueling bankrupt. Good night, Gwen, to you.
I can't believe it.
All right, Gwen.
29.
Hey, let's make it three. Why not? Good night. All right. Excuse me just a minute. Welcome back to round two of Wheel of Fortune. Top dog. Might as well start all over again. You got it,
all right, Brian.
Come on, Bobby.
All right.
Come on, keep going.
Hey, let's see if we can get three of these in a row. Okay, Anita,
no,
to you.
No, don't say that.
We have a new game here. you're on your way.
No!
All right. Seven. Anita, you're looking at the wrong flipper. You're blue. You got $700.
I'd like to buy a tee, please.
A tee? Would you believe it? There's no tee. Gwen, to you. I can't believe it. Come on, Gwen. Hey, wait a minute. Two out of two. That's some kind of record. Brian, to you. How can you make this
all
exciting?
Right, 1,000.
Come on, you guys. Come on, Brian. $400.
All right.
Okay.
I would like an N as a Nancy.
An N? There's got to be a bunch of those. A couple of million. Two of them. $800, you know your options for your turn.
I'll spin.
Okay. I might point out that you use letterboard over here. The home audience can't see
you.
You try not to reuse your letters, you lose your
turn. Come on, Tyler.
All right. Give me the right letter.
I would like a D, please, as in David.
A D?
Yep.
All right. Your turn. $1,500.
I would like to buy a vowel.
Okay.
And A, please.
One, two, three. 1, 2, 3. I thought maybe there was another one up there, but no.
All right, I'll spin.
Okay.
Come on, Bobby.
We'll buy the 1,000. See if we can make that 800. You can buy that loser turn. You got it. Can you make it? Let's go. Leave it to you. Come on, Anita.
Hey, come on, 1,000.
Come on,
yeah.
All right. Leave it turned down on that board.
Oh, shoot. I'd like to buy an L.
An L? Noel. Gwen to you.
All right.
Come on, go take it.
Come on.
$600, yes.
Okay. Is there a P, please?
A P?
Yes.
We all getting these letters. Brian, to you.
All right. I'd like to buy a vowel.
Okay.
An E, please.
1, 2, 3, 4. All right. Goodbye. Turn your turn.
Okay. I'll spin.
Okay.
$1,000,
$5,000,
$5,000,
$7,000. Come on, $1,000. Good money, sir. Sorry, $600. All right. I would like an S, please. 1, 2, 3. All right. Okay, Brian, you're getting into some serious money. $3,100 at table. I want to ask Contestants to bring it back. We've got to take a little break for commercial. We'll be right back at you. Hang on. Quotation, that's what you're looking at right there. Brian's got $3,100 in. Let's see what he's doing.
I'd like to spin.
Okay, good luck.
Come on, 1,000.
Buy the 1,000. Looking at 650 if you can hold it. Can you hold it?
No.
300.
All right, I would like a V as in Victor, please.
Yes, sir. Good answer.
Okay, I would like to buy a vowel.
Okay.
And I, please.
No I. Anita, you got it. Come on, Anita, make some money. I mean, that's not funny. You guys have homed in on that bankrupt better than anybody I've ever seen. Gwen, to you.
Okay.
No money involved. So you're done.
Come on.
Oh, Gwen, no, not you too.
Oh, not again.
Oh, come on. Look at that! Is that incredible? Brian, you got it back for nothing.
All right. I'd like to buy another vowel.
Okay.
An O, please.
Well, yeah, there's some of those. Three of them. Same options apply. You can buy a vowel, guess the puzzler's turn.
I'll spin.
Okay.
$2,900.
Come on, Big Ryan. Come on, $1,000.
Gotta stay away from that bankrupt.
$150.
I would like an R, please.
Yes. 1, 2, 3.
$3,350.
I'll spin.
Okay.
Come on, Thousand. Come on, Thousand. Looking for it. Looking for it.
Just on the other side of it. You were close.
150. Okay. I would like a Y, please.
Yeah.
Can you think?
I'm going to solve it.
Okay. I want you to, just before you do, for your information, I want you to look over and see if there's anything there you'd like to go for. I don't know. You know, just don't attempt you or anything.
Not much.
I don't know how much of a gambler I am.
Yeah.
Just one more thing. Time.
Are you, I don't want you to, I wouldn't want you to do that because I said to look over there or anything, but if there's something you want, you might want to go for it.
I'm going to solve it.
This is not tag team wrestling.
Okay, come on.
I'm going to solve it. 4 score and 7 years
you
ago.
You got it. Yeah. I didn't know. You know, there's a nice car up there. You might want to stretch your imagination and try to go for that. South Pacific Dining Room. What are you going to do?
All right. I would like the dining room furniture.
All right. $2,825.
Got it.
Good stuff.
$675.
All right. For $360, I'd like the his and her watches.
Okay. $315.
All right. For $275, I'd like the man's jade ring, please.
Yeah, all right. $40, we'll give you that on the counter and get you
a gift certificate.
Getting up there, here's Charlie O'Donnell with $3 of stuff. Charlie O'Donnell.
With your Van Cleve & Arpels gift certificate, you might select this man's ring. Rare jade, mounted in satin-finished 14-karat gold. Contemporary in style, $275. Helbro Sports Watches, sports model with one-piece case and rope bracelet for her. And for him, a matching day-and-date model of accuracy, plus another classic sports watch, furnished by Helbro's retail value, $360. And Brian, this distinctive South Pacific-style dining room furniture is constructed of maple and wicker. Lighted server has an exotic feeling with its oval windows. Table expands to accommodate 8. Furnished by W&J Sloan of Beverly Hills, $2,825.
All right.
Terrific. That's great.
Coming up, we got the ultimate homemaker's platform. We got a washer and a dryer. We got a sweeper over there. We got a sewing machine. We got a great intercom. It's a terrific intercom. And we'll come back and try to win those in this minute. Stay with us. You're having the worst luck out there. I can't believe it.
One of the cars available on today's show is Buick's 1979 Century Wagon, a mid-size family wagon with full-size quality and small car handling. The Century Wagon furnished by Buick. Now, once again, Chuck Lorre.
Thank you, Charlie O'Donnell. Here we go with round three. We're going to forge some top dollar value on the wheel for this round. $1,500. We can get rid of all the bankrupts. We'll be all right. Let's take a look at the puzzle. What's some occupation? Anita, you got a new occupation. Stay away from the bankrupt.
I'll try.
Okay,
I'll try.
All right, Anita.
All right, bye, right, Anita.
$200.
Is there an R?
Yes.
In rap.
You're on the board. Now, the E's on. Look at it.
Wait in your bankrupt or lose it to
you. Oh, you made it. $200.
Is there a T as in Tom?
Yes. $400. Now, I need a really quick giant hurt on that wheel now. Come on. You got to get past that loser thing. Get by it now. Hurry up.
Sorry,
going to you.
Yeah.
Come on, man. Foiled again.
Come on.
Look at this. $1,500. You all right, ready?
Yes. Is there an F check?
Yes. Get an F. $1,500 for your time.
I'd like to buy a vowel, please.
Okay.
Is there an E?
Yes.
Okay.
They're not too surprised.
Okay. I'd like to spin, please.
Come on, Grant.
Come on.
I'll be way by the 1,500.
Come on.
Maybe 650 if you can hold it. You got it.
Okay, is there a V as in Victor?
Two of them.
Okay.
Bring your son.
I'd like two of them, please. Okay. Okay. If I get that bankrupt again.
$300, okay.
Okay. Is there an N, please?
Yes.
Okay.
Give me a thing.
Okay. I'd like to buy a vowel, please.
Okay.
Is there an O? Oh.
When wrong. Brian, to you.
All right. Hold it.
Are you guys cool or are you really serious? Are we really going to take a commercial? That's what we're going to do. We'll be right back. Okay, we're running out of time. I'm going to give the wheel a final spin of the day and try to get that $1,500.
Okay. Hey, come on.
I'm going to ask you to give me a letter to the puzzle. I ask you to solve the puzzle. That's simple.
Oh, so close.
You!
I thought it was a pretty primo spin myself, wasn't it?
Come on, good vowels and consonants.
That's it. Okay.
Vowels are consonants. The vowels are worth no money. Consonants are
right.
1500. Letter, please.
Is there an M as in Mary, please?
Nope. Anita.
Is there a C?
Yes, there is.
Civil service.
Yeah, that's got it. All right. Anita, $1,900.
Oh, oh my goodness.
You did
oh,
great. Go to the utility room over here.
I got to have the washer dryer.
You do?
I got to have the washer dryer.
Listen, $640 for that.
I hope I won't have to take in laundry.
Take in laundry? No, you won't have to do that. We're trying to figure out how much you got left.
I don't know.
Now, neither do they. $1,260.
Okay. I'd love the intercom system.
Sure.
See,
you can listen to this. You can lock the room if you have the snore.
Does he ever?
Oh, that's...
The vacuum cleaner, $280 for the vacuum cleaner.
Okay. All that stuff comes in handy, I'm telling you. It does, doesn't it?
Do I have $269 left
in the
garage door?
Yeah, $605 left. You want the garage door opener?
For $269, the garage door opener.
Keep you dry. $336.
$145 for the utility table.
Okay.
And $66 for the towel.
Yeah, the rest we'll give you on a gift certificate.
A gift certificate.
You want that? Let's see how much it is. $125. Here's Charlie O'Donnell. Think about all that stuff. Charlie O?
Old World Folk Designs were the inspiration for this super set of towels. Deep, rich colors make them great bath accents. Retail value $66. This little tilt-top table is completely portable, made in West Germany of steel and treated wood. It's ideal to use as a little extra desk or sewing table. Retail value $145. Genie Automatic Garage Door Opener, featuring Sequensor and Cryptar 2 digital controls with 3,000 codes available. It opens and closes your garage door from inside your car. Automatic Garage Door Opener furnished by Alliance. Retail value $269. Hoover's Concept 1, a remarkable new vacuum cleaner with a dramatic difference. It's power-driven, furnished by the Hoover Company. Retail value $280. Rittenhouse Home Communicator System. Enjoy entertaining communications, door entry security. Also, Williamsburg clock chimes with 8-note Westminster melody furnished by Rittenhouse. Retail value $375. And Whirlpool's large capacity automatic washer with water and energy saving selectors. Double duty agitator and self-cleaning filter. Also, clothes dryer in gas or electric with extra large capacity. Custom dry control and hamper door furnished by Whirlpool Corporation. Retail value $640.
Let's take a look at the final scores and announce our winners.
Well, Gwen had bankruptitis today. You just didn't do well. You didn't do very well at all. You got $5,500, so that's not too bad over the last 2 days. Gwen, $1,900. Brian, $4,900. He's coming back. And he'll be up.
Some contestants will receive Light and Easy. The lightweight iron from General Electric handles the same ironing jobs as a heavier iron. And a gift certificate from Ben Franklin Stores. We carry national brands at prices you like. Discover Ben Franklin. We bring variety to life. And seal a meal you're cooking. Airtight bags to go from freezer to hot water. No mess, no bother. Daisy Seal a Meal simplifies your life. And kids' fashions from Winnie the Pooh and Sears. Spring looks, colors, and patterns, and matching washable fabrics of short quality pure delight. And Foster Grant sunglasses with polarized mirror and gradient lenses. Isn't that you behind those Foster Grants? And Pilot Pens, the razor point with the extra fine point. And the fine liner that even writes through carbons. More than just something to write with. The price of the prize for furniture to the contestants prior to the show and have to round it off to the nearest dollar.
Did Nipsey Russell say no? Find out if you play a game of Punch and ESP Mind Reader. And now, here's the star of Mind Readers, Dick Martin.
Hello. How are you? Welcome to Mind Readers, the game that explores just how much men and women really know about each other. And to help us find that answer, we have our celebrity team captains, Patty Duke Aston and Nipsey Russell. Go! Well, we've got an exciting one going here. Nipsey Russell has $50 with his men, and Patty Duke Aston and her ladies have $250. Now, the women can win with one question, and we're going to do it right now.
Wow!
Isn't this exciting?
No!
Oh, yes!
Yeah, this okay. isn't the end of us. In fact, we're only starting it. If we don't make it, we're going to put the blame on Dick Martin.
Okay, Nipsey. Patty, we're going to play Mind Readers now and just see, put you to work and see how many of these girls you can mind read.
Okay.
And here's the first question. Ladies, have you ever deliberately set out to seduce a man? Please vote now. Your votes will be registered backstage. Have you ever deliberately set out to seduce a man? Now, Patty, if you recall...
Who wants to know?
I wonder. As you recall, Jan has been married a few times, and she has a grandson.
Five, up for the next.
Five, that's right. We might as well tell on
her.
What do you think she said, yes or no? Has she ever deliberately set out to seduce a man?
Look at those dimples. Look at those eyes. Who needs to mind read? Of course she has.
Jan, Patty says you said yes. What do you say?
How do you think I got the five husbands?
You said
yes.
Yes, all right. Beautiful. Is that wild? Okay. Ladies, this is your chance to build your bank by mind reading 10 members of the jury. Will the 10 people chosen at random from our studio audience please come down into the jury box, and we're going to be right back after this.
We're about to witness an Allarest alert, a signal from your body that your allergy is coming on strong. Itchy, watery eyes, runny nose, endless sneezing. An Allarest alert needs the strong relief of Allarest, the strong medicine. Strong antihistamine relief for your watery eyes, your sneezing, plus a decongestant for your runny nose. The highest level of allergy relief you can buy without a prescription. Allarest alert, get Allarest, the strong allergy medicine.
Hi, Lucky.
Pardon?
Country Bob, handy-dandy butter churns here with the churn of your dreams.
Butter churn?
For making your buttery-tasting townhouse crackers.
But there's no butter in them. Townhouse crackers are so good because they have a rich buttery taste only Elfin Magic can give them.
Delicious.
We don't need a churn.
Well, of course you don't. Listen, these little beauties make great lamps. Just look at that.
Keebler Townhouse Crackers for a rich buttery taste.
Okay, girls, this is your chance to build your bank by mind-reading 10 members of our jury. Catherine, come on, let's go take a look at this jury. What do you say? Right over here, and here's your microphone. Talk into this microphone. Now, let's look at this jury. We have one, two, three, four women, and one, two, three, four, five, six men. Aha, good-looking jury, right? Think you can mind-read them? Here we go, then. Here's the first jury question. Have you ever eaten snails? Please vote now. Well, they're all in now. How many sophisticates do you think we have out there? How many people have eaten snails?
Oh, dear, dear, dear. Let me see. Oh, looking at them, probably about three.
Three, all right. We're down here to three, and if it lands on three, you win $500 for your team. If it's in the area from one to five, you win $200. Let's find out. How many have eaten snails? One, you're in the area. Don't worry, you have won $200. Wait a minute. This is exciting. Let me tell you how this works now. You have $200 up there. In just a few minutes, we're going to play for 10 times that or $2,000 or even more. So, Barbara, come down here and take a look at this jury. You go back up and say hello to her. Hey, come on, Barbara. Beautiful. Okay, here's the second jury question. Have you ever seen a porno movie? Please vote now. Oh, look how quick those votes got in there. Oh, this is
a hard one because of the home video cassette machines and all that stuff, everybody.
How many up there you think of...
Okay, I'll have to say five.
Five, okay. Right down here on five. If it lands on five, you win $500 to go with your $200. If it lands in the area between three and seven, you win another $200. Let's find out. How many have seen a porno movie? Seven! That's, wow! That's beautiful. That's another $200. That's $400. Jan, come on down here. Which three of you haven't seen a porno movie?
We got you.
Okay, Jan, here's your last chance to win the big bundle. Jury, your third question. Have you read the Bible within the last month? Have you read any part of the Bible in the last month? Please vote now. All the votes are in. Okay, Jan, take a look at them. How many you think have read the Bible in the last month?
They all look like angels. They probably all have. But I will say six.
Six, okay. We're down here on six. And if it lands on six, $500. Anywhere in the area between four and eight, it's another $200. Okay. How many have read the Bible in the last month? Let's find out. Three, just outside. Don't worry, don't worry. Look up there. You've won $400 for your team. Or rather, the team has won $400. Now, what's going to happen is we're going to play for 10 times that or $4,000 when we play Celebrity Turnabout. Let's go back. Well, Patty, you have a team that could get pretty well here financially.
Right.
And it's that the turnabout means that you have to read Patty Duke Aston's mind. Now, if a majority of you can predict how Patty will answer one question, you'll win $4,000, okay? Here we go. Patty, you are familiar with the Lee Marvin Michelle Triola case. Do you think Michelle should have received more than $104,000? Please vote yes or no. Patty's thinking about it. She has made her choice. She now has voted yes or no. Jan, we're looking for a majority. How do you think she voted yes or no?
All of the women that I talk to seem to think that she should have. I'm going to say yes.
We have one yes. Barbara, you remember the question. You're familiar with the Lee Marvin Michelle Triola case. Do you think Michelle should have received more than $104,000? What do you think Patty said?
I think Patty thinks that everyone should go to work and everybody should be prepared to live on their own, and I think that she said no.
Okay, we have a yes and a no. It's up to Catherine. We need a majority here. What do you think Patty said?
Would you repeat the question, please?
The question is, do you think Michelle Triola should have received more than $104,000?
Oh. She's married. Patty's married, isn't
yes,
that right?
Yes, she is married.
No, I don't think...
You say she says no, so no is the answer. Okay, Patty Duke Aston, for $4,000, did you say no?
I must preface this by saying this is a very subjective answer. I happen to believe that women are just as capable of men as earning a living. The answer is no.
Yes or no? Beautiful! $4,000! That's marvelous. Okay. That's beautiful. Even the men are applauding you. Okay, here's what happens. This was our third and final game. We have to say goodbye to both teams. The ladies leave us with $4,450. The gentlemen leave us with $5,550. Thank you for being with us on Mind Readers. Thank you. We'll be right back with two new teams right after this commercial message.
Your audience is ready, so put on your dancing shoes. Reach out and touch someone.
Reach out and turn them upside down. When you have a great day, reach for the phone and share the occasion with people back home. Reach out and touch a winning smile.
Reach out and touch someone far away. Give them a call.
It's hard to say which is worse, constipation or the discomfort that often accompanies it. Doxadan can help solve both problems. It's a combination of two effective liquid medicines. One medicine by itself is an excellent laxative. The other, an effective softening ingredient to help eliminate discomfort. No other laxative combines these medicines for reliable, gentle relief of constipation and the discomfort that often accompanies it. Try Doxadan, recommended by doctors and pharmacists for years.
Have you heard about new Yes?
Yes!
The heavy-duty detergent plus fabric softener. All in one.
Yes!
Yes has all the cleaning power of any leading detergent, liquid or powder. Plus, it softens, leaves clothes smelling, fresh, and controls static cling.
Yes!
New Yes cleans and softens in just one step. Yes, detergent plus fabric softener.
Yes!
Guess who needed a new formula Nitol last night? Guess who had trouble falling asleep? That's why there's Nitol. On those occasional nights when you have trouble, new formula Nitol can help make you drowsy so you can fall asleep. Come on, America. Stop yawning. Just look for the words new formula Nitol.
Jury selected at random will receive Dean Kraft's jewelry creations. Designed with classic beauty, reflecting the harmony of elegance and style, a handsome and unusual original Primavera collection furnished by Dean Kraft. And here again is the star of Mind Readers, Dick Martin.
Okay. Nipsey and Patty, we are back for a brand new game of Mind Readers, so let's meet our new team. Here they come. There they descend upon us. Beautiful. Okay, I happen to know that we have married women and married men. And Nipsey, I'd like the group at home to see your men and to see you and say hello. And then we're going to go over and start with the women. We'll be right back with
you. All right.
Patty Poo.
Yes, darling.
Here we are.
Please, I've lost a friend of Michelle, the doctor.
Look at these nice ladies. You think you could mind read them?
I think so. I hope so.
I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll make it easy for you and see if we can get to know them a little better.
Oh, good.
Gail, tell us a little bit about you.
All right. My name is Gail Moreski. I moved from New York to Marina Del Rey, where I live and play with my husband, Jack. And I'm a beauty consultant and an undiscovered actress.
Are you
Until
really?
Today.
You really like to be an actress?
Yeah.
No kidding.
Yeah, I really want
to. Did you ever do anything in New York like that?
Yes. Not like this.
Not like this. I mean,
no.
Like that.
Yeah, like that.
That a girl.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Good
Marilyn, enough. Tell us about you.
I'm Marilyn Nucky. I'm a teacher from San Bernardino. I'm married, and my husband and I just celebrated our 25th wedding anniversary.
Oh, wow!
I think yeah. That's beautiful. 25th, that's the silver, isn't it?
That's right.
I love it. Beautiful. Gloria, tell us about you.
I'm Gloria White from Hacienda Heights. I have two beautiful children, Alisa and Steve, and I'm married to a man who's 22 years older than myself.
Uh-huh. Oh, that's nice. I like that. Mm-hmm. Good for you. Okay, now here's the rule. Each team gets to play three games, and $300 wins the game. Patsy, are you ready?
I think so.
Here we go. The first question for the ladies. Ladies, did you marry the first man with whom you had a romantic interlude? How about Gail, Pat?
Well, I get the feeling that Gail was very popular all through grade school and junior high and high school. And I can't glean from just the name Jack whether or not he went to the same schools. Mm. But I'll bet she had a little romance before Jack came along.
You say, wait a minute then, did you marry the first man? You say no.
No, she did not.
Uh-huh. Gail, she says that you say no to that. What do you say?
Well, the truth is, I practiced a lot.
Jesus!
No!
No! That's $50 for the ladies! Well, well.
Now.
That a girl. $50 for the ladies. Okay, Patty.
Marilyn's giving me a little problem, you see, because 25 years. Now, right. Marilyn would have had to have been married when she was like 18 or 19.
Quite young, yeah.
Which means that she would have to have considered a romantic interlude in the fourth grade as something pretty special.
She were about
but to. I still believe that Marilyn tested the waters before she jumped in.
You say that she... did
that Marilyn did not marry her first romantic interest.
You say no. Marilyn, she said... You said no.
Now, our husband's listening.
Well, it depends what you mean by romantic interlude.
Ha-ha! You've just...
The answer is yes.
Yes! Oh, you lose, and the men get $50.
Right. Lovely.
Wow! Okay, we need three. We're looking for $300, and we're also going right to Gloria.
See, some good girls are not so bad.
There you go. Did you marry the first man with whom you had had a romantic interlude? Do you think she said yes or no, Nip?
I think Gloria will say no. She has two lovely children. She's married to a guy who's 22 years her senior. So I think she said no, she did not marry the first man with whom she had a sexual interest.
Gloria, he said you said no. What did you say?
I had no practice. I said yes.
You said yes! Wow! The woman! It's $100 to 50, and we'll be right back after this.
Wake up to the secret of Night of Olay.
Good morning. You know, a good night's sleep is one of my best beauty secrets. This is another, Night of Olay, an incredible night cream that eases dryness while you sleep. So light and non-greasy, even your husband won't know it's there until you wake up with softer, smoother, younger-looking skin.
Night of Olay. Wake up to the secret of younger-looking skin.
And a smile makes me feel good, makes me feel nice. That's the way it should be. I'd like to see the whole world smiling with me. Coca-Cola has life. Have a coconut smile.
All right, Bubbles, get ready to hit the dirt.
I should have become an accountant.
Oh, stop worrying, kid. We're going to give this bathroom the shine of its life. Oh, no, shine's no mercy. Dig in, kid, dig in. Clean and shine. Disinfect, deodorize. We'll never scratch or leave any grit. Oh, we never do, we never do. You're doing good, kid. Now let's go down a drain together. We work hard, so you don't have to.
Dow Bathroom Cleaner with scrubbing bubbles.
Butter.
Oh, what was that?
Butter.
Parquet margarine.
Butter.
Oh. No, parquet. It says right on your lid, parquet margarine.
Butter.
Parquet. Smooth, delicious. Butter.
Parquet.
Oh, yeah.
Parquet margarine from Kraft. The flavor says butter.
Okay, the ladies have $100, the men have $50, and we're here with Nipsey Russell and the group. Now, to help you predict their answers, maybe it would help to get to know them a little better. We know they're all married.
Yeah.
So, Jim, tell us about yourself.
My name is Jim Hudson. I'm from Simi Valley. I'm a freelance medical writer specializing in neurological instrumentation.
Well, don't look at me.
I have two I have two children, Jeff and Ben, and my blood type is B positive.
Aha! Boy, we could take him on the road.
Right.
We know everything about him. How about you, Clayton?
My name is Clayton Wallace. I'm married. I have a wonderful wife and three beautiful grown daughters. Oh. I'm from Des Moines, Iowa originally. We moved to California 3 years ago. I now live in Ontario. I'm a male charge nurse in a convalescent hospital. And the greatest joy and pride of my life is I am an ordained minister.
Well, well. Oh, marvelous. Good for you. Yeah. Quite a history there. I think that could have been a series.
It could have been.
How about you, John? Tell us about you.
Dick, my name's John Kelly. I've been happily married for 19 years. I'm a lawyer in Santa Monica. I practice copycat law, and I have, for 19 years, been super happy in love.
That's beautiful. That's nice.
Well, I think I got it.
I think that gives Nipsey a foot in the door on predicting their answers right there. Just all getting right to know these gentlemen. Here's your first question. Gentlemen, I know you're all happily married, but if polygamy were legal, would you have more than one wife? Now we got to put up a please vote now. And don't forget, your vote will be registered backstage.
Jim lives in Simi Valley, and he's a law-abiding man, so if polygamy were legal,
would ye have more than one wife?
I think Jim will say no.
Ah, Jim. He said you would not have more than one wife, even if it were legal. What did you say?
Well, even inflation is starting to hit us bad, but I'd...
if it were legal.
He said,
I'd say yes. Yes. Oh,
you know, $10 goes over to the ladies. And little Patty Duke Aston. Wow! You have your chance now.
It was bad for the home team.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
I'm kind of waiting with bated breath to see what old Clayton has to say here.
Oh, he won a born-again Christian.
There you go.
I thought this was a shoo-in.
Wow. You think he'd have more than one wife if it were legal? Of course.
Well, I think that Clayton would still opt for the wife he has.
He better say.
And I think that Clayton would probably like to continue living happily, so he will stick with that one wife and not embarrass himself on television.
He will say no then. Okay, Clayton. Patty says you're going to say no. What do you say?
Well, it's true that I love women, and I love my wife, and if it were legal, I would still say no.
Yay! Okay! The ladies have $200, the men have $50, and remember, it only takes $300 to win a game.
We can't forget
well,
it.
Now, John, how about John? John has been married 19
John
years.
John Kelly has a bit of the twinkle about him. And I think he's probably got a pretty good sense of humor in hopes that his wife has. But I think also that even if it were legal, John would opt for the same one wife.
Yeah.
Santa Monica.
He would say no. Patty said you'd say no, John. What do you say?
Patty, I'm afraid that I telegraphed my punches. You read my mind perfectly. My answer is no.
Oh. No! Hey, there it is! $250. $50 for the men. Well, now, you realize, of course, that the women can win right here and now.
Oh, just one question.
This could do it. This could do it. All right, ladies, if you found a baby on your doorstep with a note inside the basket that said, please keep me, would you keep the baby? Please vote now. Yes or no? They have voted. All right, let's get with Gail. Let's find out what Gail thinks.
This is
tough. Did she say yes or no?
I'm sure that Gail loves babies, but they just moved to the marina. And where would they put it? I'm going to say Gail said she would keep it.
You say yes. Patty says you would say yes.
Take
what did you say, Gail?
How she's going to give me such a hit, I know. Such a clop.
I would give the baby $1,000, put it on a train to San Diego, and say, have a good life.
No! She said no! The money goes over and you lose. It's $100. to 250. Now, the women could still win. So, Nipsey, what do you think Marilyn would do? Would she keep the baby?
Well, Marilyn is happily married, and maybe she has a good family. I think in the interest of good citizenship, she'd turn the baby over to the proper authorities. She'll say no.
She'll say no. Marilyn, Nipsey said you'd say no. What do you say?
A baby is a baby, and I'd notify the authorities, but I'd keep it.
Oh! That's it, yes, that's pretty good. Well, well, well. Beautiful. We'll be right back after this.
With my arthritis, getting in and out of the tub can be frightening. But with Arthritis Strength Bufferin, I can ease the minor pain for hours, move better. It gives me extra strength when the arthritis first flares up. But Arthritis Strength Bufferin adds extra protection from stomach upset ordinary aspirin can cause. Sure feels good to have the extras of Arthritis Strength Bufferin.
Arthritis Strength Bufferin. Extra strength, extra protection.
Here's a great idea.
Potato peeler?
Nope.
Hair curler.
It's Vanish Bowl Freshener. Freshness in a snap. Snap it under the rim and it freshens two ways. It's always there to freshen. Then when water hits it, extra deodorizer and detergents are released, working best when and where you need it.
When the bowl's fresh, the bathroom's fresher.
Snappy idea. Vanish Bowl Freshener.
Vanish for a cleaner bowl and a fresher bathroom.
That's all the time we have for Mind Readers today, but tomorrow the ladies are going to come back and play for the big bucks. They won the $300, and they will play for the jury. We'll bring the jury in tomorrow. Nipsey, thank you very much.
How much did we get?
You won $100, ain't
it? We got 100, fellas.
You got 100 beans. And Patty Duke Aston, thank you. We will see you tomorrow on Mind Readers. Thank you very much. Bye-bye, and bye-bye.
Some of our contestants on Mind Readers will receive Sears Tough Skins, the tough denim jeans tough enough for your tough kids. Great price and great fit. Tough Skins only at Sears. Or picnic time is easy with finger-licking good Kentucky Fried Chicken and an insulated bag that you bring school. It's nice to feel so good about a meal. Or Extra Strength Windex shines more than windows. Try today's Windex on your countertop, refrigerator, stovetop, and other appliances. Or squeeze parquet from Kraft. It's a convenient way to spread that delicious creamy parquet flavor on any food you serve. Or Lip Quencher by Chapstick. The lipstick drenched in moisturizer so your lips feel as good as they look. Or the only solution, a new family health concept. One conditioner for both hair and skin. It's the only solution worth trying.
This evening, be sure to watch NBC Nightly News. The influence of George Meany, now 80, is decreasing. What is the future of the American labor movement without him? Also tonight, don't miss Chris Sarandon, Ava Gardner, and Martin Balsam heading an all-star cast in a terrifying thriller of the supernatural, The Sentinel, both on NBC. Right now, it's Password Plus, next.
A Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production.
Afternoons at...
It's more than password. It's Password Plus. Our guest stars, Elizabeth Montgomery and Wesley York. And here's the star of Password Plus, Alan Ludden.
Good to see you, you look like it. And look who we got. We've got a young man here who's playing Password for the very first time with the... Would you mind, Liz, if I called you the queen of Password? Kind of. She's one of the real important people who plays Password so well.
Demon is the word
I heard. Yeah, demon, yeah. She's a demon. She's a killer is what she is. She really plays this game.
Dear.
This is Wesley Yore, the lovely young guy from Days of Our Lives, and we'll talk about it. Welcome to Password.
Thank you, Wesley. I'm really excited about being here.
This is going to be quite a time. Let's meet our current players. Ruth Palazzo and Paul McCullough. Come in. Yeah, they make you sit up straight. You want to lower it?
We'll lower it later. No. Here's the story, Liz. You've got the champion over here on your side. His name is Paul McCullough. He has won $9,600 plus $100 in the current game, and he is a demon. I got to tell you, you got two killers over here. Now, Paul, tell us. Tell us again about what is it that you do in New York?
I do a bunch of different things.
We'll start with one. Anyone.
Okay. I work weekends in a hospital.
Yeah.
I also do some daycare work with some problem children.
Yeah.
And I also teach a thing that's known as psychocalisthenics.
Psychocalisthenics.
And you know.
And you play password pretty loose, too, I got to tell you. Watch it. All right. Now, here we have a new lady here, Ruth Palazzo. How are you, Ruth?
Fine, thank
you. Now, tell
you.
Us again about yourself.
I'm a student at Orange County College of Court Reporting. I hope to take the state exam in November. And I have a four-year-old daughter named Independence.
Independence.
Yeah.
Very good. You have also $100 in the current game, $100 over here, which means, my friends, we start right out for the game. Whoever gets this puzzle wins the game, goes on to alphabetics. Liz has the option. There's the first clue on this $200 puzzle. What are you going to do, Liz?
I'll play.
Go.
Lips.
Kiss.
You see what you do to a guy? All right, Wesley, second clue.
Opening.
Mouth.
That's it. All right. Ruth, first clue in the $200 puzzle for the game is mouth. What do you think?
Nanette Fabre. I'm sorry.
Nanette Fabre? Is it Nanette Fabre? Why Nanette Fabre?
Well, she has such a big smile.
Oh, yes. The lovely lady. She'll be happy to hear you say that. All right, here we go. Liz has the option. Gonna pass her. Oh, I didn't ask. I better ask. Is it Nanette Fabre? Wouldn't I have been sick if it had really been?
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, Liz.
Okay, I'll play.
Okay.
Petrol.
Oil.
Okay. Second clue, Wesley.
Shortage.
Gas.
All right. Ruth. Now, I promise to ask, Ruth, this is for the game. Mouth and gas. What do you think?
Oh, Jimmy Carter. Only because he's doing such a lousy job.
Is it Jimmy Carter? Oh. No. All right. Liz, you got it.
This is really a classy show.
Yes, it is. Pass or play?
I'll try it.
Okay.
Burping.
Belching.
That's it. All right, Paul. For the game, mouth, gas, and as Liz said, classy belching.
Burping a baby.
Is it burping a baby? No. All right, Wesley, you have the option this time.
Okay. There it is.
Gonna pass the play, Wesley.
I'll play.
Go.
Volcanic
eruption.
Second clue, Liz.
Molten
lava.
That's it. Paul for the game. Mouth, gas, belching, lava for the game.
Is it volcano?
Is it a volcano? Yes!
Slow start.
Yeah, the last clue was mountain. Mouth, gas, belching, lava, and mountain. Ruth, you play this game very well. We have $100 for you and a fine gift, and we thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
You have a joy. Okay, Paul, Liz. Going to your favorite. Going to alphabetics right after this commercial. So don't go away. We'll be right back.
Attention all women diagnosed with ovarian cancer in the past 15 years. In July 2018, a jury awarded $4.6 billion against Johnson & Johnson on behalf of 22 women diagnosed with ovarian cancer from using baby powder and shower-to-shower products. If you or a loved one was diagnosed with ovarian cancer and used any of these products, you may be entitled to a substantial settlement. Call now or go to ovariansettlements.com. You have a limited time to file a claim, so don't wait.
Migraines made me feel like I had no control over my days. Then I found Cove. Cove works with me to find the right migraine solution so I can have better days. Like this. Go to withcove.com to learn more.
Look, everybody wanna go and talk that. At the same time, gotta walk that. When I go to sleep, I only dream about my other dreams. Just a metaphor to show them how I think of everything. If you wanna, gotta
When you fall and can't get help,
help.
You will lie on the floor for hours or days in constant terrible anguish, which often results in a tragic outcome. But with Life Alert, one touch of a button can get you help fast.
Don't worry, help is on the way.
With any of Life Alert's three emergency systems, help can be summoned immediately, whether at home.
I've fallen and I can't get up.
In the bathroom.
I've fallen in a shower.
Or on the go.
Help, I'm in the park and I can't get up.
And batteries never need charging. Life Alert saves a life every 11 minutes.
For a free Life Alert brochure, call 1-800-692-1989. That's 1-800-692-1989. Call now, 1-800-692-1989.
It's Press Your Luck's Whammy's Biggest Whammies. This tax man doesn't give refunds.
I see financial disaster in your future.
Sunday at 4 on Buzzer.
Third time, okay. You've been here two times before. Paul, you know how to do it. We got 10 passwords up there. We arrange them alphabetically. We start the first one this time with the letter A and go alphabetically all the way through to the letter J. You get 10 of them, as you know, in 60 seconds. You have $5,000. You know that. Remember, the first word starts with A. Liz, there's the first word. Got your clue?
Mm-hmm.
All set? Okay, you're going to have 60 seconds. Good luck. Ready? Go.
Penthouse.
Apartment.
B.
Fight.
Brawl.
War.
Battle.
C.
Car.
Chassis.
Expensive.
Cadillac.
D.
Ban.
Clue.
Smell.
Clue.
Arid.
Deodorant.
E.
Foe.
Enemy.
F.
Thursday.
Friday.
G.
Paste.
Gum. Glue.
H.
Quiet.
Hush.
I.
Titanic.
Iceberg.
J.
Coat.
Jacket.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
With 20 seconds left over. 20 seconds left. Yeah. No, you had 20 seconds left. All right. You picked up $5,000. Now you have a total. Are you ready for this? This is going to be the best vacation you ever had. $14,900. What are you going to do with it?
Well, can they hear me?
Yeah, they can hear you.
Since I've been out here through my brother, I met an astrological advisor, and he says a time is coming up in September when I should take all of this and go to Las Vegas.
You're going to go to Las Vegas with it? Watch out, Vegas. Here he comes. Let's go back and play some more and see how much more you can get. Going to Vegas with it. I'd like to follow his career and see what happens in Vegas. All right, let's meet our new player. Liz, meet Toby Clark. Hello, Toby. How are you? Let's sit here. Wesley Yore, Paul McCullough, Toby Clark. Tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm married and I have two beautiful little boys, one 5 months named Alan and one 3 named Brian, and I teach piano.
And you teach piano? How do you spell Alan's name?
A-L-A-N.
Oh, okay. That's wrong, but it's okay. You made it. You ready to go? Here we go. Liz has the option. Got a pass or play, Liz?
I'll try it.
All right.
Hi. Hello.
All right. Very good, Toby. You got the first clue in the puzzle. Hello. What do you think?
Oh, is it a letter?
Is it a letter? Not a letter. Okay. Wesley has the option. You got it. We'll pass the play, Wesley.
I'll play.
Okay.
Adios.
Goodbye.
Right. Good. All right, Paul. This should certainly give it to you. Hello and goodbye. Two clues.
The Beatles had a song that name. I'll say the Beatles.
Is it the Beatles?
Oh.
Wow. Might have been. Liz has the option. Gonna play or pass, Liz?
I'll try it.
Okay.
Honolulu. Hawaii.
That's it. Three clues, Toby. Hello, goodbye, Hawaii.
Aloha.
Is it Aloha?
What?
Oh, we were all so sure. Hmm. Weren't you sure?
Yes.
Okay.
Very sure.
Now it's your option, Wes. Want to play?
Pass.
Liz?
Rose. Flower.
Yes! That's the way to read it, Wes. All right, Toby, now you have four clues. Hello, goodbye, Hawaii, flower.
Is it a lay?
Is it a lay? Hit it! All right. Toby, $100. Take three to win. We have a commercial. We'll be right back. Don't go away. This is a good week.
It's a killer.
Yes.
Come out with the clip on the air where we can see it.
I was just finalizing the paperwork.
That was horrible. That cable guy tried to make me sign a contract.
Cable companies got you captive. Get Orbi TV, quality satellite TV for just $40 a month with no contract or credit check.
And he wanted to check my credit.
Available at these fine stores or go to OrbiTV.com.
I have a structured settlement, but I need cash now.
Use it when you need it.
Call J.G. Wentworth, 877-CASH-NOW.
The bladder control aisle. You won't shop here again. Your private business is your own. The constant struggle is over. Now there's a better way. It's HDIS. We home deliver bladder control products. We understand how you feel. For over 25 years, we've home delivered to many of the 20 million Americans who deal with incontinence. We offer all brands. We pay shipping and use plain, unmarked boxes. If we can help you or someone you care for, call for your free product sample pack and $45 in money-saving coupons. Our counselors will help you choose the right product. And unlike stores, we're always in stock. You'll get what you need. Satisfaction guaranteed. HDIS. The better way.
For your free sample pack with your free catalog, $45 in money-saving coupons and free product samples, call 1-800-452-8037. That's 1-800-452-8037.
All right, here we go. 100 over here. Takes three to win. Paul has the oxen this time. There you go, Toby. Pass or play, Paul?
I'll play.
Okay.
Seesaws.
Playground.
Second clue, Toby.
Golfers. Teeter-totter.
No.
singles.
Bars.
You two guys talk about that later. All right, here we go. Last clue, Toby.
Action. Putt.
No. I have to put it up. Nobody gets to guess. Swingers. Did you have it?
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Swingers. Teeter-totters, I don't think of as, or seesaws, I don't think of as swingers.
No.
They go along with swings. I think that's what
it is. Just kind of popped out, you know?
All right. Yeah. Not too great, Paul. All right, here we go. Toby has the option.
Not up to his usual standard there.
Pass or play, Toby?
I'll play.
Okay.
Pot.
Marijuana.
Second clue, Paul.
Green. Green.
Bermuda. Clue. Grass.
Grass. Green. Bermuda Gapachi. Grass. Grass. Well, green, he was going back to grass, not green pot. All right, here we go. I don't know. Here we go. Wait. Nobody gets to guess. I'm so confused. Here we go. You get to guess, Liz.
Oh.
Swingers and grass. I'm sorry.
I don't know.
Okay, now.
Well, had I but been told I could do it the proper time, I
would. Would you like to do it again?
No, you didn't say that.
I'll let you do it again.
No, I've given up now.
All right. It just makes me feel good. She just tries to make me feel good. All right, now, Paul, your option.
I'll play.
Okay.
Balls.
How would you have felt if you'd missed it?
I would have felt very bad. Gotta tell you.
Okay, with your lowest possible voice, Wesley, swingers, grass, and balls.
Golf course.
Is it a golf course? No, but it was logical.
Good guess.
All right. Toby has the option. Thank goodness. All right. Pass or play?
Pass.
Okay, Paul.
Hit.
Stroke.
Second clue, Toby.
Green. Putt?
Yes!
Yes!
Okay, Liz. Now you have four clues up there.
Is it golf?
Is it golf? It is! Sport. Sport would have pinned it down.
What did you say before?
All golf right. Course. He said golf course. So she would, they were going for the
you
sport. See the last clue?
Him, huh?
Well, look. Look at the last clue.
If he'd slapped your
look,
hand
Paul, look at the last clue. Between. Sport. That pinpoints it down to the sport of golf, see, as opposed to golf course.
Okay.
Got it? Just want you everybody to understand. We have a commercial. We'll be back to see if they do it again or if they go.
No more.
Clean up on aisle four.
Now, it's just shopping.
Are you ready to go shopping?
Join the shopping spree on Supermarket Sweep, coming up next, right here on Buzzer. Let's play.
If you have Medicare, listen up. Medicare alone only covers 80% of your costs, leaving you to pay the rest. Changes to Medicare are no laughing matter. If you don't know the plans available now, you might end up with a doctor you're not so comfortable with. Or even worse, being forced to pay thousands in medical expenses due to coverage limitations.
That'll be how much?
Understanding all the options, let's face it, it can be downright confusing. And that's why I love Health Markets, your insurance marketplace. They search thousands of plans from leading insurance companies to find a plan that's right for you. Plans that have prescription drug coverage, dental and vision care, and that offer extra benefits you may not even know are available. Some plans may eliminate your out-of-pocket costs, like co-pays and deductibles, and there's even plans with no monthly premiums. And they can find you a plan that lets you keep your doctors. I know that's important for me. You may also qualify for special subsidies that lower your prescription drug costs. Health Markets doesn't just work for one insurance company. They work to help you, and they do it all for free.
Hi, I'm Dr. Thomas Stackhouse. It's a new Medicare year, and that means more changes and more confusion. Many people may worry about the high cost of medical care and prescription drugs. The key to maintaining your health and saving money on your health care costs is finding the right plan for you. Don't go it alone. Make sure to explore all of your options to find the right plan for your needs.
Having helped enroll people in millions of policies with an A-plus customer satisfaction rating, you can trust Health Markets. You can enroll today. So call Health Markets now for free help. It's easy to find the Medicare plan that saves you money, so you can enjoy more of the things you love.
Your insurance marketplace, Health Markets.
Call now to take advantage of this free service. Now's the time to update your coverage or enroll for the first time. Call Health Markets now. Call 1-800-674-3336. That's 1-800-674-3336. Call now.
Let's find out. Wesley and Paul over here don't have a score. The ladies have 200. This is worth 200. It means, guys, that you could tie it up. It means, ladies, you could win. And Wesley has the option. There's the first clue in the $200 puzzle. What are you going to do, Wesley?
Play.
Go.
Nazi.
German.
Right. Paul. First clue in the puzzle. German. What do you think?
Apple strudel.
Is it apple strudel?
Yeah. No. It should have been.
All right. I see. Your mind's back to something to eat. All right, here we go. What are you going to do, Liz?
I'll try it.
Okay.
Jail. Prison.
Yes, Toby. Two clues. German and prison for the game.
Concentration camp.
Is it a concentration camp? No. Wow. Ooh. All right, Wesley has the option. You got it. Pass or play, Wesley?
Pass.
Liz.
That's what I thought you'd do.
Expose.
She let her play it first, Dante.
I don't know.
Expose, she said. Expose. Yeah, let her respond.
Yeah, right. I'm sorry.
Expose. Okay.
Demonstrate.
Demonstrate? Strip.
Third clue.
Broadway. That's dumb. I'm not.
All right.
Last clue,
it's Wesley.
Really stupid.
Picture.
Show.
Yes. Yeah. Expose, demonstrate, all fine. Now, Paul, you have a chance to tie up the game here. German, prison, and show.
Night and fog.
What?
I'm sorry. I can't think of anything else. A Night and Fog is a movie that was made about the German prison camps.
Oh, is it Night and Fog?
No.
Okay. Liz has the option. You've got it. Pass or play?
I guess that's what I'm going to do.
Yeah. Okay. Two clues, Wesley. She took too long to decide.
Okay. Family.
Relations.
Feud.
Richard Dawson?
Is it Dawson? All right, it is. Now, you've got four clues up there. Paul, German, prison, show, and Dawson.
Is it Hogan's Heroes?
Is it Hogan's Heroes?
Yeah!
Dickie wouldn't have. I don't know if Dickie would have got it yet.
Dickie
Dawson.
Aww.
I tell you what, if Dickie wouldn't get it now, give him about a year and a half more, and Dickie will say Dawson right then. Want to bet? All right, here we go. This is for the game, a $200 puzzle. Toby has the option. Pass or play, Toby?
I'll play.
Okay.
Little. Tiny.
Second clue, Paul.
Small.
Minute.
Third clue, Toby.
Rooney. Mickey.
Last clue. Wesley. Paul.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. That's just, height.
Short.
All right. First clue for the game, Wesley. This is for the game. First clue is short.
Mickey Rooney.
Is it Mickey Rooney? No, but I saw him in Sugar Babies and he's wonderful. All right, here we go. Toby has the option. Pass or play?
I'll play.
All right.
Minnie.
Say it again.
Minnie. I have no idea.
Paul.
Second
clue.
Dress.
Skirt.
Yes.
I thought you said Manny.
I know, that's why I said Manny twice.
It's a mini pearl.
She said Manny.
That's why I asked you to repeat it. Last time she said more Manny. All right, now listen, you've got the game at stake here. Wesley, you got two clues up there. Clear your head. The first two, the two clues are short and skirt. I haven't got the foggiest idea. You got any idea at home? I don't have an idea. Toby has the option. This is a critical game. Pass or play?
Pass.
Okay, Paul.
Scotch.
Whiskey.
Second clue, Toby.
Pattern. Plaid.
Yes. Good. For the game. Short. Skirt. Plaid.
Is it a kilt?
Is it a kilt for the game? It is. The other two clues were man and Scotland. Short skirt. Plaid was the critical one. All right, Paul, we have to say goodbye to you, but it's not too difficult to say if you're going to Vegas, we will provide you with a little stash of $15,100. Oh. However, Paul, as a man who could be your father, may I just say, save a little. Don't take it all, don't you think?
Well,
with his luck, maybe he ought to take it all. Yeah. Anyway, let us know what happens, will you?
Okay.
You've been a delightful player. We're going to play your alphabetics, Toby, in just a moment, right after this commercial. So don't go away. We'll be right back.
We all know that movement is like medicine, but getting the movement you need to feel better can be a challenge. Now you can keep fit while you sit with QB, the world's leading compact seated elliptical. QB gives you active sitting, letting you burn calories and keep moving in an easy and low-impact way, all while you work, read, or watch TV.
I think it's really important to get people moving, and QB is an excellent way to start providing non-weight-bearing range of motion for those who have not been using their joints.
QB was named a top 10 gift by Time Magazine and has been featured all over the world with hundreds of amazing reviews. QB has developed a unique, patented technology that fits anywhere. It's whisper quiet while it works your abs and core, hip flexors, glutes, quads, hamstrings, and calves. That's more than half your body's muscle groups. Using QB is proven to expend nearly 85% more energy than sitting. The low impact can assist your rehab or physical therapy and keeps you moving for better health. And you can monitor your progress, see your strides, calories burned, and duration of use, or turn up the resistance. Your QB comes almost completely assembled, and it's perfect if you're just starting on your quest to revitalize, suffer from joint pain, mobility issues, or just want to burn extra calories while comfortably sitting.
The nice thing about the QB is when I get up in the morning, I'm really stiff between my neck, my knee, my fibromyalgia. It's great to just have a cup of coffee or read a book and sit down and stay in motion and get the blood flowing, and then I feel great.
Experts agree, sitting and being sedentary is the new smoking. Call or log on to find out how to get your QB with free shipping and a 30-day completely risk-free trial. And for ordering today, you'll also get this QB workout mat, a $30 value, free. Now keep fit while you sit with QB.
Order your QB now. Call 1-800-693-3410 or go to buyqb.com. That's 1-800-693-3410. Order now.
We will play the game, Alphabetics, tomorrow. We trust you'll be with us. It's going to be a delightful week. Tell your friends, Password's great this week, and we're counting on you. See you tomorrow.
Some of our contestants will receive Copper Tone, a complete line of suntan products for every skin under the sun. Tan, don't burn with Copper Tone. And everybody loves Icy, the cold, cold treat with a mountain peak. An iceberg in a cup full of fun and flavor furnished by Icy. And Kraft macaroni and cheese dinners. When Kraft makes the cheese sauce, you know your family's going to like it. And extra strength Windex shines more than windows. Try today's Windex on your countertop, refrigerator, stovetop, and other appliances. And the representative of our studio audience will receive Frederick Room Air Conditioner. Quality built, dependable, and energy efficient. Built to last for years of economical use. Furnished by Frederick. Woods speaking for Password Plus, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Mr. Green?
Yeah.
You need any help?
Mm-mm.
I just want you to know, I think you're the best ever.
Yeah, sure.
Want my Coke? It's okay, you can have it.
No.
Really, you can have it.
Okay. A Coke and a smile.
Makes me feel good. Makes me feel nice.
the way it should be. I like to see
the
whole world smiling with me. Don't Dakota has life. Have a good day.
Thanks, Mean Joe.
Smile.
Tomorrow on Surveys and Polls Mondays, here's what you'll be seeing.
One of those sticks, it's all down the list. Let's go.
Just one hand, please, Michael, and a flat one for me. Thank you. Dollar values have tripled. People surveyed, top three answers on the board. This is going to decide if here's the question. Name a piece of jewelry made with pearls.
Not the record-breaking numbers, but
the necklace.
A good for a comeback.
We're playing. I'll read it one more time. I get you. You got 3 seconds to answer it, and I can't repeat it, but it's easy. Piece of jewelry made with pearls.
Ring.
3 seconds,
Pat. Earring.
If earring's there, you play for $10,000. Earring. Hey, don't leave me yet. I had a good time with Alice rushing off. You're nice people. Gonna make that $250. Now we've got $100 to start the bank account.
Right?
You, these are good people. Try and use you on our other show because you didn't win here.
10 a.m. Eastern, 7 a.m. Pacific. Every Monday, polls and surveys Monday. Every Monday. Tune in for Surveys and Polls Mondays tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. Eastern, 7 a.m. Pacific. Sunday Surprise returns this time next Sunday at 10 a.m. Eastern, 7 a.m. Pacific. Well, that's all for Sunday Surprise. We'll be back next Sunday for another big surprise for you. Until then, night. Sunday Surprise next Sunday at this time on both of my YouTube channels.